Don and Mike show, and they'll say what they wish.
Where else would you rather be than right here, right now?
No!
All those pseudo-celebrities, all of those never-was and has-beens. And I know that there's one that Rob wants, but Rob will never be able to get his endorsement. Oh, I hate them. Sorry, Rob.
It's a true story. He was a neo-Nazi with one true enemy. Himself. A man of faith. A man of hate. And his soul torn apart. Viewer discretion advised.
And, of course, I'm talking about Bob Hope.
No. I'm talking about another guy, and there's a chance that they save his brain. By the way, is it Wednesday? Good afternoon, Mr.
All right, that's a private joke, Rob. Rob called me today and thought it was Wednesday, and it's actually
Seems
Tuesday.
Seems like Wednesday. I can understand that mistake.
Feels it, doesn't it?
Because you shave your head again.
That's right. Feeling good, high and tight. Good afternoon, Mr. and Mrs. Downtown Dumbass and all the ships at sea. Hey, these guys are newts. Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara.
Thank you, Rob, and hi, thank you for listening, everybody. Don and Mike show, new episode on this Tuesday, August
Fiverr.
Tuesday.
Right.
Yeah, go Buzz. No phone number.
Hi, Don and Mike. Buzz Burbank
hi,
here.
Hi, Buzz.
Is anyone listening? Hey, Rob. Shut up. Did you wash the ass today?
Someone call for a doctor?
Yeah, running out of music there.
There it all is.
Running out of music. There are too many of those has-been, never were, where are they now tapes today. And besides, you should know the phone number.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, it's 877-365-3636. For any of the handful of stations that are currently broadcasting the show on the Westwood One Radio Network, if you're listening to us in Canada, this is what we like to call the final month.
Good riddance!
Phone number 800-636-1067. But no matter what happens, the phone number that will always work is 202-432-1067. That's the line here on WJFK in Washington. That's right. That's our local line.
Yes, it is.
Because things are happening behind the scenes on the Don and Mike show that we will not trouble you with today.
Yeah, Vin Diesel's not around here, but it's fast and it's furious.
And it's not Triple X either, Mike.
No tattoos on anybody's neck.
I want to tell you, there's nothing Triple X about it. It's rated PG for pretty gross.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the discussions that have gone on between various members of our camp and members of the other camp.
Well, the show today would certainly be rated PG for pretty gross.
Well, depending on how fast people start showing up.
Mm-hmm.
Now, listen, we promoted this yesterday. Our doors are open. And we're prepared to give away thousands of dollars in cash today.
Wow.
Here's the dealio. Tuesday, August 5th, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's encompassed in the month of August, and August is officially National Baked Beans Month.
Yep, and my favorite brand, as I mentioned yesterday, New England's favorite, B&M.
So what you want to do is come down here to the Don and Mike World Headquarters, also known as radio station WJFK 106.7.
Uh-huh.
We're at 10800 Main Street, Fairfax. You can't miss it. Giant neon sign outside says, Don and Mike still work here.
Is this made in our laboratories?
I know. This comes from pullmyfinger.com.
Wow. Very good.
So the deal is you come down, you bring your cans of baked beans, you enter the studio, you eat them, and then you go in another room for 45 minutes where you will be watched by Joe or somebody to make sure that you're not, like, filling yourself with other stuff that could make you fart, although you could certainly do that before you got here.
The sales guy whose tie we burned up just walked by.
Mm.
I just thought I'd point that out to you. I don't know if I got a look or not, and I don't know what his name is, but he walked by.
Well, let me just say to him, you're welcome. And to everybody else out there listening, come on down.
Yeah.
Because we have $500 for the best male fart, $500 for the best female fart, and $500 for what we've decided is the category entitled Most Unique Fart.
Yay!
So come on down. I know we said we started at 3 o'clock right as soon as the show started. Frankly, I was in more just ridiculous meetings, so I'm not sure if anybody's even here yet.
I don't know whether they are. I've seen producer Charlie Broyhill scurrying about, which usually indicates someone's here.
However, there are not tarpaulins. There aren't tarps in the studio.
Probably not necessary for tarps for this particular endeavor.
You don't think so? All right, well, anyway, listen, our group...
I'm smacking somebody if there is.
Good. We are ready to entertain your entrance to the studio. Hi, Charles.
There are three contestants so far, two men and one woman.
Outstanding. Well, then we'll bring them in just a second, let them eat the beans... Give them 45 minutes, as what the doctor said, to digest, and they'll come in, and they will have only one chance. And there's no time limit. Although, like, there's like maybe a five-minute time limit on how long they can bend their ass in front of the microphone and let us have the best beefer they've got.
Right.
And that's today's show. I mean, we got other stuff, but that's a large part of today's show.
Very exciting.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hello, my friend.
How you doing? Don, I was just calling to wish you a very happy wedding anniversary coming up shortly.
Well, yeah, now listen, you know, like my dad used to say, don't thank me for something that hasn't happened yet. It could still fall apart in the next 2 days, but all plans are on.
Thank you for being married for that amount of time.
For the anniversary with Frida, which will be 22 years on Thursday.
Wow. 22, that's not any particular silver, wooden, golden, or any, it's kind of the... It's a tweener, right? You're about... What,
I think it's...
You'll be 3 years away from your silver.
Correct.
That's expensive. That's all it means.
Yeah, expensive. Yeah, you got that right. Thank you, my friend.
I have a five-year on Thursday. I also wanted to tell you, I hope Tim Sabian gets his head out of his ass because you guys rock, and I want you on in Philly.
Well, thank you very much. Unfortunately,
you got 4 minutes to get Sabian here.
We just were in conference.
Find out just how serious I really
were just in conference with a major doctor, Dr. Sphinct, in Philadelphia, who said Tim's head is unfortunately horribly stuck there.
Well, it's permanent, and nobody wants to admit that, but it's permanent. And Dr. Sphinct has indicated that there is no coming back from that.
It's much like those Siamese twins that were joined, and actually what it is, it's a giant vein, much like the Siamese twins, that goes right from the tip of Tim's closely cropped Garth Brooks-like hair, right to his butt.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I hope he gets it straightened out. We'll miss you.
It'll be a miracle if it happens, and we'll let you know.
Mm. Well, we're gonna miss a lot of you guys.
Yeah.
We're going to miss a lot of you guys.
We are.
But we're going to wait until next week to say our final goodbyes.
Yes. Yeah. Well, you know, hopefully everything will work out.
Or not even goodbye, just adieu.
Adieu.
Adieu until, you know, another time.
Amen.
But for now, let's just look forward.
I think it was Alan Freed who said, it's not goodbye, it's just so long.
That's right. Alan Freed, legendary rock and roll disc jockey.
Thank you, Robbie. And last night, I don't know how many of you guys caught this football game. I know that I did because the Packers were playing,
right.
And I understand the safety concerns of playing football. They're playing in a high school field that's AstroTurf, but not really even modern AstroTurf. It's like 30-year-old AstroTurf, and the stands are all built out of metal, and it starts raining, and it starts lightning. So they pull the players off the field, and you don't want to have a football player hit by lightning.
Right.
And you would think that ABC, especially with all the resources of ESPN, that they would have a backup plan ready just in case, because this did happen 20 years ago in 1980, and I got to say, I remember the game. Green Bay Packers, San Diego Chargers. It's when they used to play the Hall of Fame game on Saturday.
Did they have it in Green Bay?
No, it's always in Canton. It's always in Canton.
All right.
And it rained and it lightninged so much that they had to cancel the game.
Where was the game last night?
Canton, Ohio.
Same location.
Every year.
Wow.
Canton, Ohio. That's where the Hall of Fame is.
Well, you said 1980? You mean, so it happened in the exact same stadium?
Yes, in 1980.
And that's the only time in 20 years it's ever happened?
Correct.
Wow.
But, still, my point is, there was a precedent. It has happened.
Yes.
So, you're watching the game and it's boring. You know, Brett Favre plays one series. Priest Holmes plays one series for Kansas City. And then you got
to... Did I just hear correctly? Did you say what I just thought you said? You said it's boring? I've never heard you describe a football game as boring.
It's boring for most of you.
Right.
For me, I'm still watching.
I see.
I'm watching the progress of...
You're making notes on your depth chart.
This number 56 for the Packers, the linebacker. I'm noting that this number 15 for Kansas City is a decent backup quarterback. And I'm enjoying it, even though the score is like 9 to nothing, and there's nobody really of any note playing in this game. Well, it starts raining again, and what they do is they pull off the players off the field, and then you go to that awkward shot of Al Michaels and John Madden in the booth.
Do you believe in miracles?
And, you know, John Madden looks so... it's a combination of constipation, irritation, boredom, and just the fact that even though John Madden is a multimillionaire, you know he doesn't act like one.
Right? Yeah, you're staying around, you know.
But Al Michaels is one of those guys who is a millionaire and acts like it.
Right.
And likes throwing out the $9 words when they're doing the game. And, and you know, I've never thought it's a really good matching like it was when he worked with, who's that Alzheimer's guy?
Oh, Pat Summerall.
Pat Summerall. So you would think that they would have a way to fill. So what they do, we asked Pat Summerall, we got him on the phone. We said, Pat, what did you think about the game last night?
Yeah, I don't remember.
Yeah. That's all he says.
That's all he has to say about it.
Now, this is ABC, this is ESPN, right. It's a combination. Here's what they announce. Well, it's lightning, and that's dangerous, so we're going to delay the game. In the meantime, please stand by for this edition of the funniest commercials you've never seen before.
That's sad.
We'll be back to pick the game up. We'll be right back. And then the camera's on them, and it's that awkward where they're on camera and they're waiting to go to something else.
Worst thing you can do to a person on TV.
You're both Madden and Michaels are standing there just looking. And then they go, like in the olden days, they go to a slide.
It's the fault of the announcer, incidentally. The way I understand the world of TV is when the announcer rushes it a little bit, then, you know, they've got their hard times that they have to break, and... TV's Barbara Harrison would be the grand dam of rushing through the exit line so that she has that awkward moment that always, I mean, almost on a daily basis, if you want to see somebody awkward on camera, watch Barbara Harrison say, we'll be back with more in 20 minutes.
Yeah, and then it's just her big face looking in the screen. So these guys are standing there and it's awkward, and then... What do they do there at ABC, the third most powerful over-the-air network in the world? They put up a slide like you would in the 1950s. Just a slide, a yellow slide.
The kind of slide that comes out automatically sometimes when there's a power failure.
Yeah, like it's a, you know, technical problem. And it just says ABC on it.
Uh-huh. Very nice.
And this runs for 15 seconds.
Wow.
And there's no audio, there's no nothing. And then they go right to this already in progress totally BS show, which incidentally is hosted by Dan Patrick and some other schmuck from ESPN, about the funniest commercials you've never seen.
Wow.
Now, at this point, of course, I pick up the telephone, and I'm calling Broyhill, and I'm saying, is this the worst moment you've ever seen on Monday Night Football? And he says, I can't believe this. He says, hold on, wait a minute. Turn it back up. Because as abruptly as they went to this awful Dick Clark-like blooper show hosted by the ESPN guys, they go back to the stadium.
Right.
And it does not appear to be raining anymore. I mean, there's no more big bolts of lightning. And you see John Madden with his hands in his pockets. Never a good sign. And Al Michaels standing there. And Al Michaels announces, we've just gotten on the phone with Commissioner Paul Tagliabue, who's watching the game on television. And the commissioner has decided to call tonight's game.
Oh, man.
And all over America, you can hear for the 10 or 20 million idiots like myself that were actually watching this meaningless preseason game, you could just hear all of us go, oh, F you. I mean, there was a little lightning. And
would you have preferred them to stay away and then come back with the game, you know, after a little delay?
Absolutely. They waited exactly 12 minutes. They ran this piece of S show.
Like they do in baseball.
Yeah. So then they come back. You know, in baseball, they've always got, like, this week in baseball queued up, ready to go.
Well, and in baseball, they're also, they take it pretty seriously. Well, of course, that's regular season. I'm not sure about I was at a postponed game exhibition, but, you know.
So they come back and they go, so our final score is 9-0 with 5 minutes and 36 seconds left in the third quarter.
Wow, so you missed almost a whole half.
Don't forget, we'll be back in 2 weeks with the Rams against whoever it is.
for everybody at ABC Sports.
Good night. And they didn't even do that. They just cut right back to...
Let's go back to the funniest commercials with Dan Patrick.
They also, they burned a lot of their filler when that guy got injured, too. I mean, they had to fill, like, probably 15 minutes.
The deal is one of the Kansas City guys got his head hit on the ground.
Is he all right today? Did he turn out to be okay?
He had feeling before they left the stadium.
Okay.
But because this happens, that apparently, you know, here's the thing. You can have a guy who's laying on the ground, who's broken both of his arms, and is lying, rolling around in pain, and the announcers say, that was a great hit. We'll check on the progress of Johnny Jackoff. We'll be right back. Bum, 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 bum. But if it's a guy who they got to bring the stretcher out for,
right,
they can't break for commercials. Right. And they have to speak in hushed, you know.
You're taking a look down there and seeing if there's any feeling.
You know, that
I don't understand how that possibly could have happened. Men hurtling each other, hurtling at each other at 40 miles an hour.
You know, and they're playing on what really is like just the street outside your house.
Right.
And, of course, it's very hushed. And this is a moment. What did Al Michaels say? This is a moment when color lines, team lines don't really matter. It's every man out there thinking about their fallen comrade, and I'm looking at this, and I'm feeling empathy for the guy, sure, hoping he's okay, but I'm thinking, you know, hey, boys, this would be a great time to go to commercial, because you know that the guy's going to be on the field for 20 minutes. That's the way they do it now. Mm-hmm. I mean, they take every...
Well, obviously, with the combination of circumstances, with the rain delay and that major injury, they were out of gas.
Yeah, so they just decided...
Let's go to the funny commercials.
What the hell? Let's sign it off. See you in 2 weeks.
I believe he's got Timmy in his toes. Let's go to the funny ads.
So that...
No, I'm sorry, that's lightning. Okay, both lightning came down on the field. Let's go to the funny commercial.
So it was bad. It was really bad. Wow. As a football fan, it was bad. Not a good omen that the first game was played in Japan.
Right.
I never liked that. I never liked the fact that we take our game elsewhere and play it in front of foreigners. And, you know, hey, let's not forget Japan. Hello?
Forget,
right.
Mm-hmm.
Remember sneak attack.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Never forget. So you've got that, and then now you've got another bad omen: the fact that the second meaningless game of the year they canceled it, and then the third meaningless game of the year, which I'm looking forward to, I'm not going to be able to watch because it's my anniversary on Thursday night. So already,
TiVo.
Yeah, but already I'm just feeling it's not going to work out for me.
Do you feel this is a bad omen for the season?
Yeah. Yes, I
do. You do?
Yes, I do.
Really?
Because I have so much emotion built into this, like you do with the Red Sox.
Right.
I mean, even in these meaningless games with the teams that generally, with the exception of the Packers, I don't care about, it's a big part of my, it's what gets me through the week.
Right.
I mean, really, to be honest with you, and I went through the TiVo, it was fantastic, because I went through, I'm going to TiVo like 8 games this weekend, because all of the teams that are out of town, they don't show the games on live TV,
right?
Like Miami or Carolina or Jacksonville, but they do show the games at 2:00 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Now, who's going to get up at 2:00 in the morning to watch a game between Jacksonville and Miami?
Now that you have TiVo, not you.
Yeah, right.
But if you didn't have TiVo, you would.
And don't even get me going on the new sideline C.
No.
I mean, all she is Melissa Stark with darker features and bigger boobs.
Hey, that's fine with me.
And I'm not opposed to darker features or bigger boobs. It's just she's on too much, and it's the deal where, and I know it's during the Hall of Fame game, so I'm just nitpicking, but she's down there talking to Marcus Allen, you know, never asking the question that you would ask Marcus Allen.
A Sacramento TV reporter?
No, Lisa Guerrero?
Marcus
Allen, the football player.
Ah, very good, okay.
You know, what you really want to say to him, hey, congratulations on making the Hall of Fame.
Right.
Are you ever going to talk to Al Davis again? Hey, dude, what was the deal with OJ? Did you bang Nicole or what? I mean, that's the question you want to ask.
Sure.
But while she's verbally giving him a handy, the action is going on the field.
Right.
And the Packers fumble and the Chiefs pick it up. And all of this is just, nobody breaks in to say, hey, hello, hey, Chiquita, Guess what?
Was she statistic-laden like many of these sideline reporters normally are?
No, she seems to be much more up close and personal.
Oh.
You know, to where, like, she was rubbing whoever the old fossil is that owns the Chiefs. You know, the guy, I mean, he is just one big age spot. Lamar Hunt is the guy's name.
Lamar Hunt. Looks like a bird.
You know that his glasses went from halfway up his forehead to the bottom of his nose? These were big glasses.
And he got some bad teeth. I mean, those are fake teeth. But
sure.
But they're bad. But she's doing
breath from the grave.
She's doing that thing where she's like rubbing his shoulder while she's talking to him.
Right. Wow.
So you know he's feeling something.
I like her already. See, the way you're describing her, I like her.
Yeah. He's feeling something down there. I don't know. It's just
and Melissa Stark was just too beauty pageant.
You don't cancel a football game.
No.
You just don't cancel.
You're not going to blame the sideline reporter for that, though.
No, I'm sure they asked her opinion. No, I'm not going to blame her, Mike. I'm going to blame the dimwits at ABC.
Well, it's ABC.
Right. You don't cancel a football game. I'm sure this is exactly how it went.
Smith Eisner. Over.
Hi, Smith. How are you?
Eisner. Mr. Eisner, we have a problem tonight.
Yes.
Have you been watching Monday Night Football on your ABC-owned Disney ABC station?
No, I have no interest in that. It's a preseason game. I was watching Fantasia.
It is the third quarter, and it is raining, and we have a decision to make. There is a chance that we will run over 11 o'clock and lose some of our network inventory. I don't like to say this, sir, but we believe it would be in the best interest of Disney Incorporated to cancel the game. Smith, over.
Smith, tell me, will we maximize our revenue if we cancel the game, or will we maximize it if we play the whole game?
Sir, we can fit all the commercials into the next 10 minutes, and we have that great special that you endorsed, the best commercials you've never seen, hosted by Dan Patrick, ready to go over.
And, of course, Smith, we will save on the electricity also for the broadcast. And the overtime for some of the employees, we will be able to get them in any reasonable. Don't laugh at me.
Yes, sir. The best news is that there will be no post-game meal for John Madden.
That's fantastic. Cancel the game, Smith. Call the commissioner.
We did have one problem, sir, in the stands. There was a bit of lightning, and apparently one of the spectators claims to have been hit by lightning. Looking for...
Any witnesses?
No witnesses. Looking for options. Over.
The options would be... give them a free $15 coupon to the Disney store in their local mall. Send them an autographed football, not one of the expensive ones, one of those white and brown ones. And give a call to the widow.
He's not dead yet, sir.
Well, if he is, give a call to the widow. Otherwise, give a $5 coupon to the bride of the stricken man.
So is it $5 if he lives and $15 if he dies, sir?
$5 if he lives, $15 if he lives, and, of course, the cheap football. And in the event that he lives, you don't need to put any signatures on that football. Forge them.
Smith out.
Call Speedwag. Thank you, Smith. Good job. I'll send you some antelope boots.
I love you, sir.
I love you, Smith.
The Eisner Empire.
That's how it works.
Controlled by television.
Mm-hmm.
All sports are controlled by the TV.
That's exactly how it works. Hello, Don and Mike show. Hello? Jesse.
Yeah, what's going on, Don? First time caller here.
Hey, Jesse.
Hey, how are you?
That was a sham last night. What'd you think about that?
Jesse, when did you tune into the show today?
No, I'm talking about the football game last night.
Yeah, Jesse, come on, Jesse, dial it in. Jesse, I've been on this topic for 15 minutes.
Yes, I know.
Why didn't you just ask Don what he thought about it? He's just gotten done.
He said it's telling
you. He told you.
It sucked. They should not have canceled the game.
Exactly.
Thank you, Jesse.
Yeah, Packers suck. I want to bone your wife.
What kind of individual was up watching the preseason game?
There you go. Packers suck, and everybody wants to bone my wife.
That's a compliment.
Incidentally, how's your girlfriend doing? Oh, that's right. Don't have one. Hi, Don and Mike show.
Guys?
Hello?
Hey.
Hey.
I had the answer to your hope or pope.
Really? You mean that old bet?
Yeah, I found out what it was.
All right.
I recorded the episodes, and I was listening to them.
Okay, that's
called an episode.
That's the first sign that it's pathetic.
Not pathetic. You know, I can't listen to you during the day.
All right, so you taped the show, okay.
Yeah, I taped the show.
All right, so what was the deal with the hope or pope bet?
All right, Buzz and Rob had it right. They had hope. Don and Mike, you had pope.
Oh. All right, well, congratulations to Buzz and Rob. Wow.
Congratulations, guys.
And I have to, I think it's, you know, when I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And I have to eat a little crow here. The fact is that it is indeed Nutella is the spread. I did some research. And
Buzz, I have to say also, as long as, thank you for the call, my friend.
No problem, Don. Mm-hmm.
As long as we're just being honest here. Yes. I was so ready to rat you out today because about the Nutella thing. Because I'm watching the Today Show, and they're doing the thing about how Kobe Bryant has lost this endorsement.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy for the Today Show says, and the sponsors have started to drop Kobe Bryant, including popular sandwich spread Nutella.
Mm-hmm.
So I called Mike,
right,
and I said, now, you're not going to believe this. On the Today Show,
mm-hmm,
they just said Nutella, not Nutella.
So right before the show, mm-hmm, up there next to Lisa called the company,
really,
and asked specifically how is it pronounced, and they said Nutella. Now with the fact that I'm agreeing that you were right about, mm-hmm, this, the fact is it's a commie pronunciation because it's a foreign pronunciation.
Yes.
If you Americanize it, it's Nutella.
That's true. And on
it's
their
Nutella. Because it's a bunch of foreigners.
That's right. And on their website, they say that the word is derived, exactly as you said on the air yesterday, from the word nut. So
yes, exactly.
That was their thinking,
Europe,
anyway.
If you have a peanut, it's, mm-hmm, no, in Europe it would be a peanut.
Yeah, but Bono had one.
Well,
yeah.
No, but I mean, I really think they say newt.
Well, let's go to a...
Fascinating.
Let's go to something we haven't done in a long time, the Pat Summerall Magic 8 Ball.
Oh, good.
Let's
all right, very
let's
good. Yeah, settle this once and for all.
Now, we have to ask just yes or no
very
questions.
Good.
You know, for instance, Nutella, is that how you pronounce it? Pat Summerall Magic 8 Ball, is it Nutella?
I said to my dad, and he said, let me see if I understand this right. He said, I think you ought to take it.
That would be a yes, I believe. No?
I don't know. It's not
let's
very
ask,
clear.
Let's ask the other way.
All right.
Pat Summerall 8 Ball,
is Nutella the correct pronunciation?
Pat Summerall 8 Ball.
I said to whoever I was talking to at the time, I said, that's kind of funny looking. He said, yeah, that's where they invented the atom bomb.
I'm not getting anything from this. It's inconclusive.
Yes, it is.
No, and it's an awful lot of words on that little triangle.
All right, let's ask one more. It has nothing to do with this. Pat, are you able to have a solid bowel movement? Can Pat Summerall have a solid bowel movement? Pat Summerall Magic 8 Ball.
He would get on the plane and just lie down in the aisle. And that's the only way he could bring himself to do it.
Well.
Like, so he's saying he does if he lies down in the aisle?
I believe so. I don't know. Do you have one more question? If you got one more, we can go with it.
Pat, I have a very serious question. Will the Boston Red Sox win the World Series this year?
Now, Mike, excellent one for the Pat Summerall 8 Ball.
That was the practice. The first move was to hook him under the neck. Might hurt him. He might not be able to speak for a few days, but, you know, that was just the way it was.
I'm not getting anything from
him. I don't know.
I really don't understand this.
Will the Red Sox make the playoffs? That's our bet. Will the Red Sox make the playoffs? Pat Summerall, 8 Ball.
I can remember a couple of times stopping and getting out and just finding an open field. And cows had been there before us, so it was a little hazardous.
It's beginning to develop a low-grade headache with this going on.
Pat, can you just tell us an answer to one question on your Magic 8 Ball? Can you answer a question, Pat Summerall?
Yeah, I don't remember.
Okay. Well, as usual, inconclusive results would be Pat Summerall Ball.
There you go. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, guys. I just wanted to help Mike out. He said that, it's a German product, and they pronounce nut as nuss. So that's where they would get the Nutella from.
Well, wait. Hold on a second. Well, how are you pronouncing it?
No.
Like N-U-H, Nutella?
Sort of along that line, yeah.
Well, then wait a minute. Then is it new or nuh? Because I'll tell you, if it's nuh is closer to nuh than new is.
Okay, now I thought I had it right, but you're sort of confusing me here.
No, you're the one that said the German. How does a German pronounce nut? Do they say
nut?
They say newt.
Let's ask Pat Summerall.
Absolutely not.
Pat, how does a German pronounce nut? Pat?
It was just a bunch of guys who enjoyed playing the game with an opportunity to play for a living. A meager living, but a living.
That's so much on that triangle.
Well,
he's been no help. And now we don't even know because that guy's entered in a third pronunciation.
Right.
Okay, Mike, let me speak with Arnold. He'll know.
No, Arnold doesn't know because he's Austrian.
Okay, good. You are disqualified. Before we, I know here. Before we get to the people coming in eating the beans, and before I play something for you that I think you're really gonna love. Where is it? You already loaded up, Robbie?
Yeah.
Oh, listen, my kid goes away to school next week, but last night he sets me up. I'm not gonna play in this break, but he sets me up. I get home from work. He's up on the computer, and he says, "Hey, Dad." "Yes?" Ready for whatever thought-provoking question he has.
Yeah.
"In your opinion, who's the greatest musician of all time?" And I said, "Well, Bart, that's an easy one. It's Brian Wilson. You know, I've got a real boner for Brian Wilson and the Beach Boys." He said, "And what is it you say about him all the time?" And I said, "It's my opinion that future generations will look at Brian Wilson as if he were Beethoven." Mm-hmm. This is just my opinion.
Right.
"I've always loved Brian Wilson. I love the Beach Boys." And then Bart said, "Dad, you know how you play all those tapes with Elvis when Elvis was all effed up?" And I said, "Yeah." And he said, "Listen to this. I'll play you just a moment of it here."
Mm-hmm. "Where's that Beach bum? Hey, yeah. Give your hands together for Brian Wilson.
This is at Ringo Starr's birthday party."
"Hello. Hello. How?
He must have been at Van Dyke Parks. Van Dyke Parks is the biggest butthole. The biggest butthole in the world."
And this is before... This is before all the stuff with the real brain damage. This is simply Brian Wilson.
Right.
Drunk and high.
Mm-hmm.
Attempting to sing for Ringo Starr, Barbara Ann.
Oh, no.
The classic Beach Boys song.
Oh, man, that is wasted.
I can't help you, guys. You don't play them keyboards, bro? Hey, yeah, no. Whoa, whoa. I bet you one for the cheaper, one for two. A one for the money, was a power to a lottery.
Let me just stop right there. I'll play it for you in its entirety.
Wow.
In uno momento.
Oh, my God.
And, Rob, do we have, how about some 60-second timer, please? Because Mike went to see the fag movie Seabiscuit last night.
Right? Yes.
And I want to make sure that we highlight your review.
Yes.
Of Seabiscuit. Now, this is not... A review of
that amazing. I've never experienced this at a movie.
A review of a movie that we haven't seen. I think you know my position.
Mm-hmm.
That if you've got a vagina, you're going to love Seabiscuit. But Mike is, you know, one of these romantic type guys who likes these movies.
Well, I was told, not by certainly more than one person, that this was going to be a movie that was going to make me feel emotional at the end, and it was going to be very moving. And I think there was an outside shot that it might have been.
And now keep in mind, this is also a segment on Joe's Book Club.
Yes, and I'll be honest with you, the ending, which was read by Joe, it wasn't part of the movie.
Right. Here with a 60-second review of the movie he has seen, my friend Mike on Fag Horse Movie, Seabiscuit.
Seabiscuit by Mike. Ladies and gentlemen, I've said so many wonderful things, glowing things about this film, and I must tell you, it was wonderful. It was very exciting. When you go into the theater, I was 44 years old when I went into the theater to see Seabiscuit. I was 46 years old when I came out.
Oh, no.
This movie makes Gandhi look like a trailer.
Wow.
This is a long movie. This movie starred Jeff Bridges, and it's with Lloyd Bridges. This is a long film. So long that I kind of lost my energy for it. And it was fine. But it was not the movie I expected. I was disappointed, not because the storyline wasn't riveting. The horse races were riveting, but it's just long. And when you see one horse race, and then you see two, and then you just see horses, and you see...
How many dead horses' heads do you give this movie?
I give it two. That is all. Two out of four.
Wow. Two out of four.
It could have been a lot better.
Okay. There you go. You heard it from Mr. Sensitive.
The movie started with Tobey Maguire. It ended with Paul Maguire.
Wow.
It's a very, very difficult movie to watch in its entirety.
You heard it right there, Mr. Wow. Sensitive. Mr. But cried at the movie Rudy.
It was very, very difficult.
Thank you, Mike.
It started with Sea Biscuit. It ended with Sea Loaf of Bread.
Your balls started with
Sea Biscuit. It ended with Dead Sea Biscuit.
Your balls are growing.
Yeah.
The more you say this.
Well, you know what? I just didn't. It didn't do it for me.
You know what? I'm gonna
too long.
Gonna make a prediction.
Any movie that's that long, I don't want to be told a story that long.
You're gonna get laid tonight. You are gonna get
by
laid
a horse
tonight.
Wow. Did I not want to love that movie?
You did.
You did.
You wanted to come back and say all that stuff.
Walked out wishing that I'd gone to see the American Pie movie.
Yeah.
That's what I wanted to do. Or Pirates of the Caribbean.
Amen.
Which I got a personal endorsement from Mr. Burbank as I was going to the movies last night.
Well, you know, he's got that pirate thing going.
Yeah. And you know what? The thing that sucked was, you know, I had a little date last night. Was going to do dinner.
Hey.
Dinner and a movie.
Hey.
But here's the deal. Because the movie was so long, I said, hey, we'll go to the 7:25 show, and then we'll grab a bite afterwards.
Every time.
And, you know, the only place to eat was Denny's.
Hi. Class.
Hey, where could I go? It's not New York City, you know. Yeah. It's not like you can go to a, you know, sit down at 10:30 at night and have a decent meal.
You know where you take her back to eat?
Where?
Serving steak tonight.
No, you steak and taters. Right here. Steak and taters.
You take the young lady back to your place.
Good acting, but, you know.
Oh, come on, no, don't try to sugarcoat it now. You didn't.
No, I mean, it wasn't all that bad. It's 2 stars. I mean, I've given movies less, but a long movie.
Yeah, Mike hated it.
We're talking long.
I love it. Yeah, good for you.
I didn't hate it.
Good for men.
I didn't like it as much as I thought.
Good for men everywhere. That's your masculine.
Little frustrating.
Yeah, there were the touchstones. Just take a call 100 right now. 877-365-3636 for the secret sound. And when we get back.
Takes place in the 30s, and when the movie's over, it's Futurama.
What network shows the reruns of that? Futurama.
Futurama on Cartoon Network, right after Adult Swim.
When we come back, we'll have the people start eating the beans, too. Be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
What exactly are we looking at here?
What do you mean? What?
Well, I mean, is it the, what the...
Is it the Frank or the Beans?
I don't know. It looks like, I think it's a little bit of both.
Break them veins! Break them veins!
What's that bubble there?
What do you think? It's a...
Well, how the hell did you get the beans above the Frank? I mean, I
don't know. It wasn't like it was a well-thought-out plan.
You know, there really does seem to be an awful lot of skin coming through there, so I need to find some vaccine, honey.
The Don and Mike Show.
Baby ain't working right.
Two solid men who work with their hands for ye. Don Geronimo and Michael Mara.
There you go.
Look at these things.
There you go. Problem solved. Time for a call number 100. And, I don't know. Pick a line, Mike.
3.
They're all ringing. Hello, Don and Mike.
And call 100?
Yeah, my friend. What's your name?
This is Steve.
Steve, where are you from?
Salt Lake City.
Steve, great news. I bet you don't get this in Salt Lake. 15 Oscar Mayer Big Eats Griller Sausages.
Oh, baby! Mm.
Fresh off the grill at 7-Eleven. And a 7-Eleven convenient card.
Isn't Utah a vegetarian state?
Utah. We consume more meat and jello than anybody per capita in the nation.
Whether you're craving an all-American hot dog or want to be more adventurous, 7-Eleven has it all. But wait, hold on a second. Trying to find anything that's anti-Utah. Oh, Sex in the City prize pack.
Ooh!
Don't miss the all-new season of HBO's hit series Sex in the City Sunday nights at 9.
Sex.
8 Central Time every Sunday only on on Hobo HBO, and you won the Game Freedom Pass, head to your local participating Blockbuster store to get your Game Freedom Pass for $19.99. Yours is free, and you get to rent a game every day for 30 consecutive days with no extended viewing fees. Enjoy, my friend.
All right, I'm down with all that. Thank you much.
So we've already beaten the odds. How long have we been on in Salt Lake City? We've been on like, 2 months now, something like that?
Yeah, it's going to be a heck of a run.
And they think that. Yeah.
We want to keep you guys here. You guys do a good job.
Thank you. We appreciate it. Keep listening until September, right. Until September 1st.
And we appreciate it.
We do. Now, for $1,000, the secret sound, and the clue given yesterday, I believe, was weather.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Weather.
That's right.
That was the clue given yesterday, and Buzz was able to figure out the secret sound based on that one clue.
Narrowed it down.
Now, my friend, if you are smart or lucky.
Oh, I go smart.
You know, and me.
Buzz figures out a lot of them.
Me, I'm lucky. I'm not a smart guy. I'm a lucky guy.
I'm not a smart guy, and that's why I never get them until.
What was the clue?
What?
The clue was weather.
Weather.
And I don't get them normally until after the listeners get them. And then after the listeners guess correctly, I usually always get it.
You know what I'm saying? I'd rather be smart than lucky, or is it the other way?
I'd rather be lucky than dumb. I'd rather be lucky than smart.
Yeah.
So.
Well, whatever.
We're all so dumb we don't even know the same.
I wish I were lucky.
I'm on the good side of that equation.
Better to be lucky than good.
Because I'm dumb and I'm lucky. And remember, if you're not cheating, you're not trying. And also remember this. Eating ain't cheating.
That's right.
Hooray.
Okay? Yeah. Now, for $1,000, we'll play the song, give you 15 seconds to think about it. Please don't answer until Mike sings like
Tiffany.
Tiffany, hey. We wish you Godspeed.
Caller, name this sound.
There it is. Now, I know, Buzz, you're waiting to hear Mike sing. I think we're alone now. Forget the Tiffany Darwish was quite the chart topper.
The flowers you gave me are just about to die. When I think about you, what could have been, it makes me want to cry.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, Mike, embrace the new direction. I like the new direction. I vetoed one, and then the other one I wasn't really fond of.
Which one you vetoed?
Tracy Ullman.
Oh, now that was one I picked.
I didn't know it.
They don't know about us.
They don't know the Bean Eaters are coming down the hall.
Okay, listen, here you go.
Oh, God.
Pride of Salt Lake City on the line for $1,000. What is that sound?
That is the sound of an umbrella.
You're going to have to be more specific.
The little switch that closes the umbrella is like an automatic umbrella.
He's made a selection.
Rob, no. Very...
Oh, we're sorry.
I'm sorry. You have no idea. You have no idea. No friggin' idea.
Yeah.
Thank you, my friend. Don't forget that every guess is a clue for you.
Clue for you.
A clue for you. And now Mike is frantically writing me a note. Well, yeah. Yeah. There you go, Seabiscuit. There you go. You got it.
Yay.
There you go.
Yeah. You know how I got it?
How?
I can't say, because if I say it, I'll give it away.
I know. So anyway, that means tomorrow the jackpot goes down to
$500.
$500.
$500.
And we'll be able to have side bets on if we get a winner or not tomorrow. And, you know, we don't even do this contest every day.
It's pretty obvious. I think everybody should know it. Honest to God. Come on, people. Get with the program, okay? What's he got to do? Hit you over the head with it?
Be smart like Mike. Figure it out. Like Mike and that guy in Salt Lake City.
Absolutely, yep. And, he was way off, but it just the whole weather thing, I finally realized I was thinking like Buzz was thinking, and now I know.
Mm-hmm. Really? You were thinking like Buzz?
Yep, absolutely. I was thinking in that nudie way that he does.
Picturing everybody naked?
That's it.
And everybody listening right now, I'd urge everyone out there, you know, like that WWJD, What Would Jesus Do?
Mm-hmm.
BSLM. Be smart like Mike.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Win this contest tomorrow.
That's right.
Win the contest.
That's right.
Okay, bring him in.
Are we bringing them all in at the same time?
Wheel of... Yeah, they're all coming at once.
I see a winner in the group.
Now, the deal is, it's Baked Bean Month. The month of August is Baked Bean Month in America. And it's a long list. It's a long...
Oh, look at them. My God, what a motley crew this is.
Winner. These beautiful people. Now, we've got Baked Beans Month. We have Ice Cream Month. Also in August, you have Tennis Month. Peach Ice Cream Month, Caviar Month, let me see, Tennis Month, National Tug of War Month.
This is so funny. Everybody's, it's like the first day of school. Everybody's got their bag of lunch.
Amelia Earhart Month.
Right.
Take Your Pants for a Walk Month. Chocolate Milk Month. Cheese Month.
This is all in August?
All in August.
Jesus.
And we've decided to capitalize on simply... the Baked Beans phenomenon.
That's fantastic. I think that's great.
So now the deal is you will be the first four contestants. We have one girl and three guys. Mm-hmm. You're going to eat your baked beans, and then you're going to go to a back room where you will be watched by Joe to make sure you're not ingesting anything else. Then 45 minutes from now, for the time you eat, you're going to come in the studio.
I got my favorite already.
And be given between...
And he's wearing a great T-shirt.
Between 3 and 5 minutes to squeeze out your best part.
You the man!
Let's start with him. Step up and what's your name, my friend?
My name is Darren.
Hi, Darren. Where are you from?
Woodbridge, Virginia.
All right, Darren, what do you do for a living, sir?
General contracting, landscaping, and auto detailing, all at once.
There you go. All right.
And you are no stranger to the world of baked beans?
No, I'm not.
All right, what brand have you brought today?
What did I get?
What are these? He's getting his beans out?
Bushes.
Nice. Bushes.
Maple-cured bacon.
Fantastic. A little maple-cured bacon probably help you along.
Hey, Charles, I think we need a can opener in here.
Yeah, we desperately need a can opener.
That's the one thing we need is a can opener. Did you bring one?
Now, are we going to have everybody eat their beans at the same time?
Yeah. Girl contestant brought her can opener, so why don't, while you open your can...
You know, Don, I can actually do this while people are talking to you. I can open these cans.
All right, and Charlie brought a can opener in as well.
Slide that over here, sir, and I'll take care
and,
of that.
And let's talk to our female contestant, if you would step up, please. Hi.
Hello.
What's your name?
Jen.
Hi, Jen. Where are you from?
D.C.
From D.C. Thank you for being the first woman brave enough to come down to this competition.
Yeah.
If no other girls show up, you're guaranteed to win
$500. Well, I'm hoping to beat these guys out in the uniqueness and everything. And the smell,
too. So. Oh, dear. That's terrific.
Are you a big farter?
I was last night, so I'm hoping, you know.
Okay, outstanding.
They're your beans, sir. And Jen, you want me to open that can for you?
Right, let's meet our third contestant in the champion undershirt. What's your name, sir?
Joe from Naples.
Hi, Joe, and what do you do, sir?
I'm a carpenter.
Oh, well, thank you for listening.
Hi, we're a carpenter.
What kind of beans will you be eating today?
I have Bush's maple cured bacon as well.
There you go. All right, but now your can is not
this
as...
This is the third can of Bush's that we've had so far. Very popular beans.
Your can is not as big as the other guy's can.
I can do a lot with a little bit of fuel.
All right, and Atlanta Braves fans, step up. What's your name?
I'm Jeremy.
Jeremy, where are you from?
Manassas.
Jeremy Slacker, what do you do?
I'm unemployed.
See, I called it.
I think I just want to say it's always great to have Prince William County represented in one of our games.
And what kind of beans do you have?
I had to go with the on sale at Giant
Campbell's pork and beans.
But they got the pull off top. I didn't think that anyone would have it.
Yeah, so you don't get any extra points for that.
Does anybody have a napkin?
No,
Campbell thinks so.
I have some.
All right, these are yours, Jen.
Yeah, I'll use the paper thing.
All right, and what we need is for you guys. Hey, Charlie, can you get Mike number 5 hooked up? Mike, here's some more napkins for
you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
What we'll need to do is get all of you around the microphones eating very loudly because I think we're going to have maybe like a 45-second limit on as fast as you can eat these beans.
So you got to sort of power eat them and try to go. Let's before
now,
we start our
hold
beans.
Hold on. There's a fifth guy, too. Are you playing, too?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, and what's your name?
Hi, my name is Chris. I'm from Philadelphia.
Chris from Philly.
Wow. Yeah,
Drexel University.
You came all the way down. Have you ever been here before?
Yeah, I was here for the sausage.
Yes, I remember Drexel. You were here for the sausage hit.
That's right.
You know, thank you for supporting this show.
You know the guy that broke my hand, right?
No.
Okay. No, I remember that guy. That guy's
he's not the guy that broke your hand.
Is it broken?
Charlie, you can move it.
Not anymore. It's fine now.
Thanks, Will.
The guy's name is...
Appreciate it.
Mic number 5, let me turn it on, Robbie.
Can you hear my voice?
There you go.
Hello, then.
All right, well, then, let's, Rob, if you would strategically get all of the people around the various microphones. I think you guys are going to have to share, and I think you guys are going to have to share here, microphone number 4.
Ma'am?
And, my lovely, you can have number 3. And what we'd like is very loud slurping. and eating.
Get right on the mic.
And if you guys are ready.
Don, is 45 seconds or 60 seconds for the...
Well, let's give them 60.
Yeah. 60 seconds to enjoy your beans and whenever you're ready.
Eat as loudly as you can. Go.
Some are drinking the juice first. And now it's an interesting strategy. You cut your lip?
Maybe.
Now eat up. You're wasting valuable time talking.
Blood.
Operate.
Just like copper.
Mm-hmm.
Most people drinking the beans, not eating the beans.
Our girl over here is just power chugging.
Very seriously enjoying her beans.
Honey, you still got 30 seconds to go.
Take your time. It's not an eating contest. It's a farting contest.
How are you boys with the Campbell's beans doing?
Doing all right.
You doing all right?
Good.
And now what about in the back there, you guys? How you doing?
No, we're good.
Doing very well.
For the blood.
Did you really open up your lip on the can?
Just like it.
Yeah.
Less talking now. 14 seconds. 14 seconds.
Wow.
Drink those beans.
And five, four, three, two,
and that's it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please put your cans in the trash. The eating segment of the competition is now closed.
Now, there's one good thing. I'm sorry, I forgot your name in the gray T-shirt. What's your first name?
Darren.
Darren is sweating.
Darren was sweating when he came in.
But it's a good sign that he's sweating more now.
I know we're judging, so we can't wager, but I just have a good feeling about Darren. Please don't let me down. I don't like to be let down, you know.
I would say I like confidence. And I like the fact that she's...
Jen?
Yep.
I agree. I think Jen is going to be a stand-up contestant.
Now, this is not the end of the contest. We're going to leave this open for a couple of hours. You're the first wave. Well, we'd like to... Hey, Joe? Where is the world's oldest phone screener? Joe Ardinger will escort you guys out.
I have a question, Don.
Yeah, Mike.
Now, there's a time limit that they have to be able to produce
by... It already started 45 minutes from 1 minute ago.
And they have to come in at that mark, right?
Yes, and they will each be in this room with the same microphones and put the mics down by their asses.
We give them a reasonable amount of time when they raise their hand. That means they're ready, and that's what we will judge them on.
You pull the mic down by your ass. If you want to bend over, if you want to... do some stretching, do some yoga. At 4:52, you will all be back in the studio, and you'll each be given, as a group, you'll be given 3 minutes to fart.
And in fairness to the workers that work here, that is the microphone that will be the designated farting microphone, okay? We'll have that at a level for you to enjoy, and that's one. Not this one, honey. No, not this one. Honey?
Honey,
you ain't going to use this one, honey.
Well, God knows worse things have happened in that one.
Well, I think you and I, for a while there, were, made a regular part, but it's ours.
Yeah. I know.
And Ron Bennington's.
All right, so Joe, take them out, please. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you all.
It was a pleasure meeting you guys.
Thanks for coming.
There
they go. Jen, take that home. You've got an extra can. Enjoy that.
All right, listen, no sneaking anything.
She was very generous. She was offering me a can of baked beans.
That's why...
That's nice.
That's
lots of carbohydrates.
That's why Joe's going to be back there watching them. Now, as we discussed yesterday with a bunch of the assistant producers we have listening to the show, everybody was concerned that... they could eat something before they came in. Well, that's out of our hands.
Right. There's nothing. If somebody wanted to prep for this,
it's baked bean month.
Might be why Tiny's sweating already.
Could be.
It's like conditioning before a big race.
Absolutely. I think Tiny was probably ready to rip one right when he came in here.
And like that Seabiscuit thing, a lot of that stuff I read about those jockeys, trying to hit their weight.
Yeah. Oh, they did the old binge and purge thing, and that's what Tobey Maguire does in the movie.
Right. Mm. And same like with wrestling in high school, that you always had to get weighed. It wasn't bad enough that you had to wear that gay outfit and that thing that looked like Princess Leia's
the ear on your ear.
Right. That you had to go get weighed, and like if you were 1 pound over, the coach would say, okay, well, eat some salt pills and then put your finger down your throat.
You know what I was wondering watching Seabiscuit though? Because Tobey Maguire looked so different than he did in Spider-Man. And then I know Spider-Man 2 is just around the corner, right? I mean, that guy, just dramatic changes in his appearance all the time.
He's he's an actor.
But, I'm talking about weight.
Yeah, he did that all naturally. He actually did do it by working out, and he's bulking back up for Spider-Man 2.
Wow, that's pretty, because he really does get down to it where he almost looks unhealthy.
Wow. He and Tom Hanks in Castaway.
Absolutely. They're just so spectacular.
And
long movie.
Philadelphia, too.
Philadelphia. Right, the 8th movie.
Right.
Of course. Thank you, Rob. What would we do without Rob, who thinks it's Wednesday? Rob was absolutely floored when I told him. He called me about something today. And I said,
you're kidding.
I said, what are you talking about? He said, it's Wednesday. And I said, well,
get out of town.
Maybe part of it has to do with my wonderful godson, who I just heard in the background having a Damien-like moment. Rob's talking to me on the phone, and baby Robert is really a blood-curdling screaming in the background.
Yeah, right. he was time for his nap. And, you know, he doesn't... We always know it's nap time before he does.
Right.
And sometimes he just doesn't listen. He gets that from his mom.
I said, Rob, maybe the reason you think it's Wednesday is because that's going on.
Yeah, it could have had something to do
and
with it.
And it was at that point we said, good day to you, sir.
Good.
I said good day.
Good day. I would bid you a fond farewell. See you tomorrow on Friday.
So those are your contestants for the baked bean contest. Mm-hmm. Now, when we come back... Oh, now I've just been told that this is great for tomorrow's show.
Good.
You're going to love this. And I'm going to use the M word because I have to. I'm not going to say dwarfs. I'm going to use the M word.
Well, you know, I mean, Scotty's still in the listening area. He could come down here and he'd want to open up a can of whoop-ass on you.
This is how this was presented to us and a guest we're going to have on the show tomorrow.
Hmm.
A guy named Rob and his girlfriend named Brooke, who is a midget in porno, they're making a movie. The World's Smallest Gangbang. Are you a midget? We need you. What does the World's Smallest Gangbang have to offer you? Sex with famous midget porn star Brooke Hunter. A once-in-a-lifetime experience. After the shoot, you receive 5 free adult videos to compensate you for your time.
That's all they get. Wow.
Yeah. What will happen on the day of
That's a bargain.
What will happen on the day of the shoot? What do I have to do to be in the gangbang? And what they're looking for is midgets who want to be in a porno. And as it turns out, Brooke Hunter stars in pornos with midgets. However, she is a regular, standard-sized woman.
But that's all she does?
That's all she does. She specializes in midget porno.
Ah, very good.
When I was researching this today, one of the requirements is that the female little people have to be okay with wearing a strap-on.
Really?
Yeah. So,
Wow.
I've just gotten the great news that, who says we don't get the big guests on the Don and Mike show?
Fantastic. Is the lady coming on?
I think just the guy.
Of course.
Just the guy.
Yes, of course.
Just the guy, because that's how it always is.
Yeah.
Hi, here's what we're looking for. But that's tomorrow, and I got the Brian Wilson thing, my hero, and once you hear this, it's on par, perhaps worse than any of the Elvis tapes.
Yeah, it's much worse than
we've ever played.
As effed up as Elvis was, Brian Wilson eclipses him on this.
So anyway, that's coming, and then they'll be right back with the burping and the farting. More show coming right up.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Me? That's why the bosses sent me out here. They wanted me to make sure none of the other crews robbed the joint. Like these two balloon heads over here. They were going to try to bang us out of 200 grand? Yeah, right, I'm sure.
The Don and Mike Show.
Is anyone listening?
You can call Don and Mike anytime from anywhere in America. 877-365-3636. They're ready to believe you.
I listen to this and I say...
Hey, what?
I don't know, Brian.
Someone call for a doctor? Because here's Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara. Someone call for a doctor?
Okay. So Brian Wilson is, my musical hero.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, before that, and I'm not trying to be controversial or shock jockish, I agree with Mark Cuban.
Oh, no.
I do. Mark Cuban said some dumb things that I agree with.
Well, no, I don't think there's anything. I frankly, as far as the sad thing is,
this is about Kobe.
I think he's right too, but I think it's. I don't know if that's a good thing.
Well,
you know, that's. I agree with him, but I think it's lousy.
I got to applaud the guy for being so stupid that he's inadvertently just saying the truth.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's, you know, you run into those type of
but
people.
By opening his mouth about it, don't you think there'll probably be some kind of backlash?
Well, there's already a backlash against the guy. The guy is the biggest jerk in basketball.
Right.
Mark Cuban, You know, Kobe's got all this stuff going on, and, right. and his court trial starts tomorrow, or at least the hearing starts tomorrow. I'll be on TV. Hopefully we'll be able to listen to it on the show. Mark Cuban was talking with Total Tool Pat O'Brien from Access Hollywood, and he said that the charges filed in Colorado against Kobe Bryant, quote, I'm going to quote Mark Cuban.
Yeah, I'd like to hear, because I have not heard the exact quote.
From a business perspective, it's great for the NBA.
Wow.
It's reality television. People love train wreck TV, and you hate to admit it, but it's the truth. It's the reality today. Notoriety sells in this day and age.
He's right.
I can't think of anyone who's going through a legal problem who doesn't get high attention. Is that cold-blooded? Yes, but it's bottom-line reality.
Okay. If he puts it that way, then I understand it more.
I don't want to compare Kobe with OJ because Kobe's case hasn't been decided. But the reality is there is more interest in Kobe now than there was before. He said the intrigue will make Dallas's season opener against the Lakers on October 28th must-see TV. Take away the personal aspect, and the reality is there'll be more people watching this game against the Lakers than there would have been before.
Wow.
Who do you know who won't watch the Lakers' first game with Kobe?
And I would say to Mark Cuban that notoriety, just like fame, is, in fact, even more so than regular fame, is more fleeting. And I don't doubt that he'll have a spike in the interest, but it also goes away real quick.
Well, but the thing is, this thing with Kobe might not go away real quick.
But if the trial lasts a long time, yeah, but what I'm saying is, once all is said and done, that after that notoriety, you know, you're basically, you know, at the expense of Kobe, or maybe not at the expense of Kobe. It's just a...
What I don't get is why Kobe just doesn't do what Michael Jackson does. Why doesn't he just, like, say to the girl, okay, how much do you want?
Right.
You know, how do you think Michael Jackson really has gotten away with, you know, sleeping with all these kids?
Well, I mean, hasn't it been almost documented that he's paid off some of these parents kids?
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, you bought a $4 million ring for your wife. You write this girl, whether it was consensual or not, you're going to be screwed either way.
Mm-hmm.
Pardon the pun. You say, how much?
But do you think that the notoriety factor with Kobe will have legs in the NBA? I think an initial splash, but I think kind of thing fades away.
The longer it goes on.
Well, I mean, if once it's over.
And the fact that the Lakers have added Karl Malone and Gary Payton and Shaq's toe is okay. And that they're going to be gunning after San Antonio. Yeah, everywhere he goes is going to be a freaking circus.
Mm-hmm.
The longer it lasts, which is why if I'm advising Kobe, I say, listen, Kobe, okay, your wife didn't leave you. You gave her the $4 million ring. Pay off the girl in Colorado. Make it go away. But Mark Cuban is being criticized.
You're assuming that the girl in Colorado would accept the money. You know, would accept a payoff. I mean, that... Who's to say that hasn't been done behind the scenes already? You know, you don't know that.
Who's to say they haven't offered enough?
No, well, but you know, you don't know. If
listen, Mike,
I'm not making any assumptions that anybody's guilty. But in the event that it really went down,
you try it out for American Idol. I'm betting you could get her for under $2 million.
But in the event that it really went down, where there was something went on, and then from what I've heard stories that say yes, something happened. I've heard stories that say. No, nothing happened. Nobody knows. Nobody knows what the facts are.
So if it ends up with
if she was really in that situation and it got out of control and she was thrown down and he forced himself on her and it got rough and it got brutal, all the money in the world might not make a difference.
But let me say also that who's to say that this girl who has a record of psychological problems
mm-hmm.
didn't have consensual sex with Kobe,
right.
then got one of her friends and, you know, I mean, did like what Madonna did in that video. And said, or by herself, and said, let me do a CSI on myself here.
Yeah, mark yourself up and stuff on any
yeah,
possible.
I mean,
sure, I'm not saying either one. I think a lot of people feel like I do with this, where you really can't make that determination yet. It's hard. It's hard to make that determination.
You know, and I'm not. I'm just saying that this guy Mark Cuban is getting some bad press now for saying this.
I think Mark Cuban's being absolutely honest.
What he's saying is
he's not making a judgment call and saying whether it's right or wrong.
I agree. It's good for the NBA right now. Nobody's thinking about the NBA. Come October when the season starts, we're going to be caught up in the baseball playoffs, and football's going to be on, and you know basketball, it starts in October.
And did he say it's good for the NBA?
Quote, from a business perspective, it's great for the NBA.
It's a little weird. Yeah. It's just a little weird that he puts it that way. Because really, what's he saying? But what's his message to the rest of the league? Hey, guys, listen. You know, we're not getting enough heat on our particular team. Let's go out and commit a felony.
Well, if it happens, roll with it. I mean, listen.
But what about the morality of it, though? I mean, you know.
What's the morality?
It's the morality. What you're saying is it's a great thing to go rape a girl because
you don't know. You don't know that.
But what if? But the fact is, if he is guilty of rape,
if he did it, he'll be put away for 20 years.
Yeah.
And either way, it's still as shallow as it sounds.
Great for business, but is that good?
In this day and age,
I mean, all I'm saying is that a good thing?
In today's marketplace, I'm sad to say, yes.
Good in what way?
That it would make more people interested in watching the NBA, talking about the NBA.
And with the utmost respect to you and Mr. Cuban on this one, F that.
Well,
if it takes a guy getting into a rape trial to generate interest in the league.
Mike, do you watch those car chases when I call you and tell you about them?
Of course.
Okay. Do you follow, you love the O.J. thing as much as we all do.
You're confusing. I am not disagreeing with what Mark Cuban is saying. I think that when Mark Cuban makes that statement, he's absolutely right about saying, yes, it's going to generate interest.
It's great for the NBA.
It's great, but the fact is, I don't think it's that great a thing that it is great for the NBA. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
I don't disagree with him at all. He's making a statement of fact, and he's being brutally honest.
I understand what you're saying.
I'm just saying it's not a great thing. You know?
And I'd say, in answer to that, that 20 years ago, what you're saying is exactly true, but the world has changed in the last 20 years, and sad to say that this happens in all of our sports and with all of our the TV stars and movie stars, they go through bad stuff. You know this whole thing in this country. We build these people up. We build them. Look at Ben and J-Lo.
Right.
Goddamn. And we're all sick of them.
Yeah.
But we all bought into all this stuff with them being in love. I mean, Jesus Christ, I watched the Dateline show. I called Rob and said, tape it so we can play it.
Who doesn't slow down and look at an auto wreck when it's on there? I don't disagree with the guy saying, hey, factually, this is going to generate the interest. What bugs me is, you know, I think of, you know, if this really did go down, if the thing was really bad and this turns out to be a conviction and he's convicted of rape, that, you know, a crime which, incidentally, is, I mean, I guess in Colorado, the laws say the guy could go
20 years.
For life.
Yeah. 20 years of life.
And so my point is that when you make a statement like this, and I'm almost with Mark Cuban for his honesty, but yet at the same time, I think it's his responsibility as an owner to make some kind of statement within that factual to qualify.
That's why I admire the guy, that I'm sure he knows all that. But if he does all that, then his message gets kind of lost because he's being PC.
What message?
The bottom line is what he's saying. If he says
he's making a statement of fact. I don't know whether he's sending any kind of message.
He's sending
other than not a really good message.
Well, an honest message.
An honest message is not necessarily always good. I mean, if you're saying, hey, it's good for business. All right, go out. You know, hey, listen, go out.
Let me just say this. Hold on.
Get into a street
before
fight.
Before you do this, you don't know. And if there had been talk that this girl had been squeaky clean and never been in any kind of trouble,
mm-hmm.
never been a mental patient, never tried out for American Idol, mm-hmm. never been in the hospital, never been known to make up stories, I would be more inclined to be on your side. But I'm inclined to think that, yeah, Kobe Bryant banged her, but
I'm not making any statement whether I
think.
Do you understand? I'm not saying whether I haven't made my final decision as to what I think of, even with the facts as I have them. I'm not sure whether I believe he's guilty or innocent.
But here's the thing.
What I am sure of,
it is good for the NBA, because, and look at it from this standpoint. Would we be talking about it today in this context? Good or bad, we're talking about the NBA.
It's a really subtle point I'm trying to make here, is that, is this good? Does it generate interest? And from that standpoint, as far as bottom line, money, interest, fans paying attention,
yeah.
you know,
yes,
is it good for the NBA? Yeah. Is that good that it, that this is what it takes to generate interest in a league. No, that's not good at all.
And what I'm saying is, and that was my
that's point. Not good for, and I'm making that, you know, I think everybody, there's not many people that would disagree that that's not really a very good reflection on us as a society.
And and that's what I said to you 20 years ago, it would have been different. But now...
In what way?
That 20 years ago, we were a different society. 20 years ago, we weren't so much in this car wreck society where...
Right.
So... Looking at the way things are done now as opposed to even 20 years ago, you know, or Jesus Christ, 50 years ago, this would have never gotten in the newspaper to begin with. Like,
yeah, absolutely.
And all the stuff with Clinton would have never gotten in the newspaper.
It would have been swept under the carpet.
Right. So now we've got it, and I give him credit. I think he's got a really dumb haircut, and he doesn't have the best team in the league, but he has a great locker room.
Well, it's the same line that, you know, now Kobe might get other endorsements because he's got street credibility. That's kind of an offshoot of what Mark Cuban said. It's a similar type of thing that's being said right there.
From a business perspective, it's great for the NBA. But he's right. He's right.
Yeah, right or wrong, it's true.
It's now must-see TV. I bet a lot of people, if it's not decided by October 26th, will watch that first
game. Well, you know, I'm not an NBA fan, and you know, Kobe Bryant is now more of a household name than he ever was before, and that's the way we are. I mean, we love a scandal in this.
And this is part of the problem, too, that the same machine that built him up to be what he is
right
now tears him down, and they built him up unfairly as well. And he went along for the ride, more power to him. But nobody ever really knew what Kobe Bryant's like. Nobody really knows. Like I was saying on the show, nobody knows what you or I are like. God, you know, we are so much more in touch and so more intimate with our audience than a basketball player is. All you know about Kobe Bryant is when you see the commercial where he's walking by and kids are playing basketball,
right.
And he goes, hey, I'd like to play ball with you, and then I'll buy you lunch at McDonald's.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so for all of the people who live in downtown Dumbass, they think that's the real Kobe Bryant.
Yeah.
The guy that does the commercial.
Or do they? You know,
no, I mean, they do. Oh, they do.
It's strange. I mean, nobody doubts that we put our athletes and our celebrities on a, you know, on this pedestal. But it's weird. It's strange because we love to tear them down almost as much as we like to have them. You know,
Mark Cuban, more power to you.
Well, now see, that's BS.
That's my opinion.
But more power to you. So what you're saying is like yay rah rah.
I agree with him. It's great for the NBA. That's what I'm saying.
But more power, what do you mean by more power to him?
Keep speaking the truth.
But the truth is not, you know, I think you can speak the truth, and that isn't always the greatest thing in the world to say, you know, hey, fantastic.
I'd rather speak the truth than hide behind how I'm afraid it would be taken by other people. You know, like he's getting, trust me, he's getting killed for this all over the country.
I don't think I'm not disagreeing with what he's saying. But the point I'm trying to make is that really he ought to remember that it's the people that he's an owner. He makes money off of all this interest. And there is, I don't care what you say, there is at some point, there's some amount of responsibility that comes with it.
Anyway.
Don't you think?
For him?
For him and for the players.
He's a businessman. The players are businessmen. Listen, I know this. I know that Kobe Bryant wishes his genitals that he never was there that night.
Right, right.
You know, and first off, he's incredibly stupid, even if it was consensual. That he can have sex with any broad he wants.
Right.
You know, and his wife is beautiful. But, you know, you pick a mental case who wants to be an American Idol. That's the one you pick? Okay, so he's dumb in that.
I guess the way I keep thinking about it is when you listen to Mark Cuban say this, is what he's saying going to be construed by certain players as, hey, I'm going to go out and, you know, I've been behaving a certain way, but now if I behave more...
No, I don't think...
If I behave more like a thug, then I'm going to be...
No, because there's plenty
I'm going to have more interest. I mean,
there's plenty of thugs in all of our sports already.
Right, right.
It's just this is an over-the-top scandal.
Right.
And
in the long run, do you think it'll be great for the NBA? I don't know whether it will.
I don't know, because we are a very forgiving society.
Yeah, I mean, I know that.
Think about when Clinton got in trouble.
Right, right.
You know, and look at him now.
But I'm saying specifically as far as interest, maintaining the interest. Like once this fades away.
Here's the thing, like any other sport, because it's a sport, if it's good, if the teams are good,
right.
we forget.
Right.
Now, if all the games are like 2 years ago and it's 85-80 mm-hmm. and they're playing nothing but defense, well, then forget it.
You know what I'm thinking also? This is the last thing I'll say on it. You know what a part of me thinks is that if one of my daughters went through something like that and I heard this son of a bitch make that comment, I want to take his head off.
Well, first off.
That's the way I'd feel. Hey,
first off.
Great for business. You know, I'd feel a little pissed
off. Wouldn't you say to your daughter, hey, come here for a second. You know, hey, Sandy Sue, come here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I thought you were nuts to go on American Idol. You've done all these nutty things. Wouldn't you ask your daughter first, what are you doing going in Kobe Bryant's room?
You know, and then we get back to, like, who's right and who's wrong on that. As far as, I wouldn't know what the circumstances were, but in the event that I believed that, you know, that my daughter really had been violated and it was one of these situations where it really went down the way the prosecutor out in Colorado is alleging it did, I'd be mad at Mark Cuban. I'd be mad at him.
Well, I don't know.
And anybody that's probably been the father of a daughter that's had that happen to her would probably, even if it wasn't the same circumstances, would be kind of pissed off because he somehow lightens it a little bit, you know? Mm-hmm. He lightens the heaviness of the whole situation.
It's great for the NBA.
What a great quote.
What a great quote. You are a great owner.
I'm glad that got through.
Hello, Don. Your point has gotten through.
Okay. Yeah,
everything right. You've said has gotten through.
Okay. All right.
Wait, I've not turned the microphone off.
I understand that. I understand. But I mean, if you think on the other side of the coin, I think really it's because I'm the father of two daughters. That's the way I think that way.
Hello, Don and Mike. I don't doubt that.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Hello.
You're on the air. Hi.
Hi. This is Joe from the Legacy.
Hi, Joe.
How you doing?
We're doing great.
Yeah, I agree with you, Don. This is, like, the best thing that could have happened for basketball, to get all this attention going and stuff. I mean, all they need now is a slow-speed chase, you know, him and his white Escalade, and this would be the best thing going.
All right. See you later. And in a way, you know, and I understand what that guy's saying, but in a way I'm going, what do you care?
Right. Well, because we want to be entertained. Because we want to be
I don't know if it's that easy.
Just like we want Ben and J-Lo to go out, and then we want their movie to flop.
It's like when you hear a fan, it's great for basketball. It's like, you know, yeah, well, maybe you're right. Maybe we want to be entertained.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hello?
Yeah, hi.
Hey, Cuban's office are after about a lot of things, but I think I definitely have to agree with him on this. I guess I agree with Don, too, that it's pretty sad because society really focuses on, you know, negative things that happen to our professional athletes. But, In the long run, it really does, you know, boost business and it boosts interest. And I think that's just what he's trying to say.
And if, you know, listen.
I don't disagree with his facts that, yes, it will generate interest, but it just pisses me off that, you know, when he says it's great for the end. That just makes me mad. And is it a rational reaction? No. It's an irrational reaction. When I hear that, it pisses me off. I don't know why it pisses me off, but it does. It's an emotional response.
I think it's because you have daughters.
I think that's probably
it. If it was Kobe Bryant got into a fight with some guy and got in a street fight with some guy,
mm-hmm.
and they said this, I don't think you'd be as emotionally
But I also haven't made any determination. As a matter of fact, I probably skew towards the Kobe side as far as if this is a trial. I don't have all the facts yet, but it still makes me mad that he makes that statement. It's irrational, but I want to. Oh, man, it pisses me off.
Hello, Don and Mike. We have to break here because it's almost time for the people to come back and fart. And we've still not played the Brian Wilson tape. Hello?
Hey, Don, Mike, how you guys doing?
Okay.
Don, I have a question. How would you feel if, say, Mike was accused of rape himself? Do you feel that it would be good for the show?
Hey, that was a legend,
now,
okay?
Now, listen, I'll tell you something. You must not be. How long have you been listening to the show?
Since you guys came on to Philly.
Okay. Then you've only been listening about a year. I'll tell you something. It's not rape, but it was pretty awful. And as a matter of fact, it was 5 years ago today.
Really? Wow.
5 years ago today that I got busted for pot. And it was on the front page of the Washington Post. And it was on the national news. And it was on the lead story on Channel 4, 5, 7, 9, 13, 11, and 2. And as it turns out, it was a great thing for me because it's 5 years now. I haven't smoked any hooch. I'm off that crap. Looking back at it, was it bad for our show? No. No, it wasn't. I'm not endorsing it. I'm not saying you should go out and get yourself arrested.
No, I understand that.
But so I can put myself in those shoes. And trust me, at the time, I didn't come in. When I called Mike that day, I didn't call and say, hey, do I have some great news about our show?
Yeah,
I mean, I just got arrested for having a couple of joints in my car. But I have been through a similar situation. You know, nothing sexual or anything, but,
right.
You know, I mean, in this day and age, a couple of joints, just as bad.
Right.
No, and the overall, you were up front about it, admitted to what you did, and in the fallout, the long-term fallout of that, there wasn't any.
And the reason is
that at the time, personally, it was probably one of the, if not the toughest thing you've ever gone through personally.
Yeah. And
that was pretty tough for me, too.
And very hard for my family and for everybody that I work with. But I had to tell everybody individually, all you guys, listen, I'm done with that. I'm never going to party like that again. It's stupid. I had to tell my family that. I had to tell my bosses that. I had to be number one tested.
And you know, as when you make
for a year.
And when you mention forgiving, you know, society and stuff like that, I mean, people. We are a forgiving country as far as that is concerned.
Yeah, because everybody, you know, everybody screws up. So even right. if, you know, that's what I'm saying, this Kobe thing. Now, if he did do it, that's awful. That's different than having a couple of joints in your car.
Yeah.
You rape.
It's a slightly different thing.
You rape some girl. But I don't, it's my gut feeling that he didn't.
Don, you weren't hurting anybody except yourself.
Anyway, so I have been in those shoes. And I'll tell you, it didn't hurt our show. But I think it didn't hurt our show because that day, I came on and said exactly what happened.
Bingo.
And said, I promise you, our listeners who feel somehow let down by.
And then went ahead and followed through on
that
it.
That I will never, ever get in that type of trouble again, and I will never smoke pot again.
Yeah, and I think that's what did it.
And,
I mean, you know, the fact that you followed through on that.
And you guys don't know the stuff that the company made me do. You know, that for a year I had to be, you know, number one tested whenever they wanted me to. And even to this day, we still have the stuff in my house because I got an open deal with my family. Anytime you want me to take one of those tests, bring them on.
Right.
Because that's the only way that they know everything's okay. And,
but at the time, you know, it was we certainly were experienced the feeding frenzy, especially with our friends at the Washington Post, who I will remember more than anybody else, who just were doing cartwheels.
Oh, I mean,
and, you know, they're not like a tabloid paper.
No, I was the headline.
Yeah.
I was absolutely the headline. And I'll tell you one other weird thing. I don't know this. I never understood this. That whole year afterwards, I don't know why Ken Steve has always wanted to hold the cup.
Yeah, I think you know why.
When I went in the bathroom?
He didn't even mind the splatter.
No, he
counted on it.
Kind of liked it. One time he laid on the floor.
No!
And he said, come on, let's do this like a...
put the cup in his mouth.
Like a carnival.
My eyes are burning.
Like a carnival game. Hello, Don and Mike.
Don and Mike, you bad bastard.
Yeah, what?
Hey, you know what pisses me off?
What?
Don and Mike, are you there?
Yes, we're here.
I don't know. I'm sorry, I got a cell phone here. What pisses me off is I'm listening to the people going to eat beans and fart, and I'm listening about, you know, having sex with midgets, and then I got to listen to a 30-minute dissertation on the NBA and Kobe Bryant.
Oh, well, listen, I'm real sorry. You must be calling from downtown, dumbass. I'm real sorry that you're not broad enough to listen to what I thought was a pretty engaging discussion about something that an owner of a basketball team
said. If I want an engaging discussion.
If I want an engaging listener, I'll answer.
Oh, thank you.
Now you laugh because you think I'm really angry. And let me prove again, as I tried to yesterday, I'm not really angry.
Like, you couldn't go out to a bar and have a discussion about Kobe Bryant, and then a guy breaks wind at the table, and everybody laughs.
However, let me just say this.
And then you watch that midget porno.
I don't want to do it when I'm on
listening
to the radio.
Shut up.
Let me just
shut your cake, Cole.
Let me tell you one last thing, and this is not said out of anger. I swear on my son's life this is said truthfully, that you wish that we weren't on because you don't like this talk.
No, I love
you,
the show.
No, you don't.
I
like
love
this,
your show.
You don't like this segment, except this segment.
This segment, yeah, this segment.
You will get your wish very soon. You will no longer have to listen to a show in which you don't like every segment of.
And
very soon you'll get your wish.
Well, how will that be, Don?
Why don't you just stay tuned? Or
should I even give you the date?
Give me the date, Don. Give me the date.
I'm going to leave that one up to Mike.
Well, I think the date might be a little floating towards the end. We have a general idea of what the date is.
Yeah, sooner.
Where's this caller coming from?
Wichita.
Wichita, Kansas.
Right.
Well, hopefully you're not going off the radio in Wichita.
Oh, boy, hey, he's a sharp guy.
There you go. Now, you've just crystallized it.
Now, that I will hate.
Yeah, good. Well, and then you'll remember that one of the last things, in fact, probably the last thing you ever got a chance to say to us was negative.
That you didn't like what we were discussing.
Toto?
So all you want is people calling and telling you how much they enjoy segment of
it. Yes, that's what we want. Is that too much to ask for?
I don't think so.
Is that too much to ask for?
No, probably not.
Is that too much to ask
not
for?
Not too just much to ask for.
An audience full of sycophants, not an audience full of idiots like you, thinking that you know what's good. I want to tell you something, that what we just did was so out of context for us, it was good. But you're trained to think farts are funny, and farts are funny.
And we're going to have farts. In fact, the colons are bursting in the back room. but just leave it alone.
You know, and
leave it alone. Did you hear what I said?
I heard you.
And for the last time.
I'm listening.
We don't need people calling in telling us that they don't like what we're doing.
That is what slows the show down.
And the response, if you don't like it, change the station, is a valid response. Really, don't waste my time because your opinion really does not matter to me. But it's a moot point. Because, Toto, I have a feeling we're not going to be on in Kansas anymore very soon.
Well, it's a sad day out here on the yellow brick road.
Is there any last words you'd like to share with us from Kansas, please?
There he goes.
Rob.
Still great.
At some point.
They're never going to.
Some of them will hang up when I say that.
No, you know.
And I spell it out now when we do that.
Mike, not until we lose all the other cities. Not as long as there's Wichita and Sacramento.
No,
here's my dissertation.
The reason is because there will always be agenda callers, and they will always want to prolong their time on the air as much as possible.
And incidentally, his use of the word dissertation was incorrect, too, because that wasn't a dissertation. No. That was a discussion.
Yes, it was.
A discussion. We were just having a discussion.
Wow.
Whether you agree with Mike, whether you agree with me,
absolutely.
You're somewhere in the middle.
Neither one of us were lecturing anybody during that.
No, we were lecturing that last guy, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and I'm not afraid to say it. I don't want your hate calls. I don't want them. Eat me. You either love this show unconditionally.
That's right.
Or, you know, take the next boat to China.
Amen.
Yeah,
wish we could bring him back from Wichita so those people could fart in his face.
Be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Ever suck the jelly out of a jelly donut and then fill it with chocolate swirl ice cream?
I like to stuff a jelly donut with Reese's peanut butter cup, then put it in a warm oven and let the chocolate and everything melt into the dough.
How about peanut butter and jelly on a chocolate-covered graham cracker?
With thin layers of banana on top.
The crones, they got chocolate-covered orange wedges. The juice just dribbles down your chin.
Junior, could I have just a drop of honey in this, please? Just a drop.
The wedge of the actual fruit is covered with that thick, dark chocolate. You know?
Oh, boy. Had the right to stuff one of them in a donut.
Don and Mike Show. Suck me, the Don and Mike Show.
All right, bring the contestants back in. It's been 45 minutes. Oh, boy. For National Baked Bean Month, while they're making their way in, let's give Robert the Angry Mailman a second. Hey, Robert.
Hey, fellas, what's up?
Hey, what's up?
Man, Kobe is a dumbass, man. He messing up my Lakers, but my point is this. Is there any hope for marriage?
Robert, the answer is yes. I got 22 years coming this Thursday.
And once again, we will have to disagree because I must disagree with Don. No, there is no hope for marriage.
Hey, Mike.
Yes, sir.
Explain to Don that 90% of the world, marriages don't work.
No, I think it's more like 50, I think it's more like 50%, Robert. It's 50%.
Buzz, how long for you?
28 years now.
28. And Rob?
Buzz messes around.
7 years in October, and our marriage is full of hope. I know.
Yeah, that's because you
have hopes, and she hopes every day. Nothing so far, but
4 years.
Keep hope alive.
How many years for you, Rob?
Seven in October.
Wow. Way to go. I'm pulling for you.
Yeah,
you're gonna beat me.
You know what? You hope
you're just
too.
A few months away from beating me, Rob.
But hang in there, buddy. What, Robert?
Hey, Don.
What, Rob?
Charlie ask you about my little proposal?
No, I'm not talking to Charlie about your proposal.
See, everything, it's just like you said, everything has to be done on the air. My birthday is next Tuesday.
and I want a two-girl show.
You know, I don't see why not.
I think we might as well. I mean, you know, Robert would enjoy it more than anybody else.
Hold on, Robert. Yeah, we'll get it for you. Hold on a second. hold on a second. Do you want white girls or black girls?
Black girls.
Black girls.
How about a white and a black girl?
How about a black and Hispanic?
All right, a Latina and a black girl.
All right, hold on a second. Charlie, would you hook that up, please, for Robert?
We have a little ethnic birthday.
Tuesday is a birthday show. Now, let's welcome back Jennifer, Jeremy, Chris, Joe, and Darren. They came in, how long ago was this, Robbie? It's,
It should have been 57 minutes ago.
So they ate baked beans. Incidentally, you'll find this in your DJ handbook. It's National Baked Bean Month.
Super!
And now each one of them will be able to step up to the microphone number 5.
Have any of you had any creep out during the time? Oh, everybody's shaking their heads. Is everybody gonna drop the ball, so to speak?
What I'm hoping, Don, is that they can actually step up to either Mike 3 or 4, and then Mike 5 is just for their ass.
Okay.
Oh, fantastic! So they can talk to us on one microphone.
Right. And now, who wants to try to go first? There has to be someone brave enough to try. Don't make me pick one of you. Okay, there you go. Step up.
All right,
and you are?
Joe.
All right, Joe, now, will you talk into that one? And we've got the other one back by your ass.
Joe is bending over in
and
the
Joe,
prone position.
Don't worry about that. You know, give us the sounds, and let's hear.
You think you got one in there, Joe?
Yeah, I think I got one.
Oh, he's got one. All right, let's listen. Right.
Here we go.
Joe.
Wow.
Joe the man. Good start, Joe.
The man.
Good. Way to go, Joe.
Now that's official. You're done. You're all set.
Now Rob can John isolate
Joe that Rob
cannot John isolate these and bring them in for instant replay.
Speaking of the microphone, Joe,
I have more. Do I get extra credit?
Yeah. Does he get more for extra credit? You want to try one more?
Give another one. Go ahead.
If you got another one going.
Technically, you have a bit of a fart.
All right. Here we go. That really it was nothing. The first one. Stand by the first one.
Robbie,
and incidentally, yesterday when I mentioned citrus spray, do we have any kind of spray in here at all?
Mike, we got too many things going at once. We got people trying to tape and trying to
oh my God
put on the CD.
Hell,
important.
You got it, Rob. The replay
yeah, on reel 2.
On number 2. Here's the replay.
Wow. A burden call.
Good way start. To go, Joe.
Good start, Joe.
Anybody else think they're up for the challenge?
Who's next? Someone has to go next. Don't make me pick.
And incidentally, I think just to help things along, can the rest of you maybe do some jumping jacks? Well, it's a good idea.
Now,
your name, sir, is?
Darren.
All right, Darren, you think you're up for it?
Hopefully.
Now, Darren, we're going
to... By the way, I hate to jump in. How are we scoring these?
A scale of 1 to 10 decimal system, right?
Yes, and everybody has their own private...
Yes, sheet. 10 is the highest score?
10 is the highest, yes.
Right. Okay. Who is the guy just went? Joe?
Yeah, and this is Darren now.
All right, Darren.
You ready, Darren?
We'll give you a minute. Squeeze one out.
Let's listen.
Oh, might need a tarp.
Oh,
dear. Okay, don't worry.
Joe, lower that mic a little bit. Lower just
Joe, that's cake. That's another cake assignment for Joe.
Here you go, Joe. Put the microphone by his ass a little more.
I don't think anything's going to work without making a mess.
Now, whenever... well, then, you know, take a break, then. Does anybody else feel the need at all? Are you smelling something over there, sir?
Really? All right, hold on. You in the Braves jersey, I'm afraid you got to go. It's your turn.
Anybody want to jump up and down or try to get them, moving around?
Jennifer, are you ready yet?
I'm getting there.
You're getting there. All right. In the Braves jersey, what's your name, sir?
Jeremy.
All right, Jeremy. 1 minute on the clock. Are you ready? Microphone by his ass back there, guys.
Move the mic a little closer, please.
And 60 seconds go. I heard.
That's Jeremy.
Very nice.
And Charlie, I know everybody. You know, Don, you're right. There are too many things going on here. I'm just going to have to be over here.
You're taking pictures for the website.
Oh, damn.
Does that smell over there, boys? Very nice, Jeremy. And now, Charlie, is it possible John Norman can isolate each of these four so we can review them?
I don't know if he's here.
Oh, he's not here. Oh, he's not. All right.
It's the replay on reel 2.
Buzz with the spray?
Oh, God bless you, Buzz, I owe you.
Jennifer, are you ready?
Right to me. Thank you very much.
Are you ready, Jennifer?
Oh, my goodness.
Our only female contestant.
Yeah.
You oust. Hey, it's a new product.
You not seen the commercials for that?
No, I haven't.
Yeah.
Oust?
They do it like on a low budget where it looks like it was done with a home video camera.
Right.
All right, now here is our only female contestant, Jennifer. Are you ready?
All right, Jennifer.
And go.
Nothing.
All right. Nothing. Yet. Well, you got time.
A minute, right?
You got a minute.
Yeah,
you got
absolutely.
A minute.
You want to bounce up and down, whatever you want to do.
Waiting. Waiting on you, sweetheart.
I'm really worried with these people pushing. We're in danger of an accident here.
Waiting on you, sweetheart.
Not happening.
Still okay. Wait. All right, we'll come back. You have 30 seconds.
Yeah, nothing happened there, but there's still lingering effects.
We'll come back to you. All right, Nine Inch Nails, what's your name?
It's Chris.
Chris.
From Drexel University in
Philly. All
right,
Chris.
Chris, are you ready?
I'm ready.
On your mark, get set, go. These guys ate baked beans an hour ago, and girls. Nothing.
Sorry, they're all SPDs.
Oh.
All right, hold on. You've got 45 seconds left. We have some hints coming in.
Oh, good.
Devin.
Donna Mike.
Yeah.
According to the worst case scenario handbook, if you're on a date and you have bad gas, they advise you to put your elbows on the ground and stick your butt up in the air, and it's supposed to help get things flowing through the system.
All right, elbows on the ground and butt up in the air.
Butt up in the air.
All right, elbows on the ground, butt up in the air.
Thank you, Devin. Now, who hasn't gone yet?
So far, the only successful farters done have been Jeremy and Joe. Darren and Jennifer and Chris have all tried, but there's not a lot going on.
They all have time left. Jennifer, do you want to try again?
All right, whoever wants to. Oh, we're going to go. Now, Jennifer's going to try again. Here we go.
Here we go. Jennifer, only female contestant. Come on now. You're like the Annika Sorensen of farting.
Nothing. Nothing, Jennifer. And Jennifer, be careful. Just, I mean, you know, we don't want an accident here.
All right, anybody else with extra time want to go?
You know, I really suggest those of you that haven't successfully farted yet, jump up and down in place. That usually gets things going.
Yeah, go over here. Do it on the microphone. Let's hear you all jump up and down.
Come on now. Ready? One, two, three, go. Everybody that hasn't farted, sir, you've farted already. You don't need to...
Charlie, you taking these pictures for the web?
Yes.
Darren, you feeling anything coming on there?
It might be messy, but I feel something.
Oh, jeez.
Well, yeah.
How about a change of clothes?
All right, he's ready. He's ready.
Darren?
Darren, don't push too hard.
Darren, listen, if you go, you go. Don't worry about it.
It's going to be mud. I can't.
It's going to be mud.
Your brown capping?
It's going to be BM.
Turtle head's poking out.
Okay, nine-inch nails, you got more time? Both nine-inch nails and Jennifer have more time available to them.
All right, very good.
And incidentally, I should mention to the other guys who have already farted, if you think you have a better one, jump up.
You will accept that?
Yeah. Because we're giving them all more
time. I've already graded both Jeremy and Joe on their farts.
Because we're giving all of them more time. We've still got like 3 minutes left in this break if we want to stay on schedule.
Very good.
All right, now, everybody's trying different things. The gentleman from Manassas, what is your name, sir? Jeremy has... Jeremy's not doing anything. Jeremy's just
standing
in place.
Jeremy Slacker is happy with his fart. Dan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you're on the air. Hi.
How you doing? Listen, I was taking one of those physiologic classes, and come to find out that best way to do it is take and make a fist, push in on your lower intestines from your right to your left.
All right, everybody's trying. Few of the contestants.
Hi, Greg. Greg, hello.
Hey, Don and Mike.
Yeah, hi.
Man, I've been trying to get a hold of you guys for 3 years.
Okay, come on. Cut to the chase, please.
All right. The best thing that they could do, and it takes like 5 minutes to go through, is swallow air.
Swallow air, but they don't have 5 minutes.
No.
Hello, Mark.
Yeah. It's Mark. What's up? Hey, man.
Excuse me. Joe is back. This is another one, Joe.
Second attempt. Hold on there.
Go ahead, Joe.
Hey, Joe. Okay, good. Go ahead, Mark.
Hey, I'm an expert at this. I do the work all the time. Do like Tarzan, beats on his chest, but beat on your abdomen.
All right.
Beat on the abdomen. All right. Hello, Mike.
Yeah.
Hi there, you're on the air.
I'm calling from Philly area.
Wait a minute, Joe's back, ladies and gentlemen.
Hold on, Joe.
Once again, go ahead, Joe.
Go.
Oh, dear.
Joe's the one who started. I'm stuck on the blue route. I got to pull over and use the bathroom.
All right, Bobby, this guy just said he has to go to the bathroom.
I'll tell you, if this was a race, I believe Joe is beginning to lap the competition.
Joe is the Seabiscuit of this race. Just want to say that right now.
So far, Jeremy, the only other successful producer in the competition today.
Would this be a good time for me to promote the website?
Well, let's get the pictures up there first.
Okay, all right.
Station's got some new dumb website.
Ah.
Major announcement.
That's not exactly what they wanted me to say. It's a new dumb great website. In which
the new dumb website is up and running, right?
In which you're going to put pictures and stuff. Very good.
Now remember, kids, whenever you feel the urge, just jump up to the microphone.
All right, we got 1 minute left in this conference.
1 minute, otherwise it's just going to be a horse race between Joe and Jeremy.
1 minute. Hold on, let's go to Kevin on the telephone. Kevin.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Okay.
I just want to let you guys know, man, this is the funnest play-at-home game I ever did.
Oh, yes, playing at home. Yeah, you can do that.
Play at home. Hello, Sean.
The funnest.
Hello.
Sean, hi.
How you doing, buddy? Hey, maybe you should try to pull their finger. It works for my uncle.
All right.
Your uncle. All right, now.
Oh, wait, Jennifer, you going to try?
Jennifer.
Jennifer.
Keep in mind, if you just fart, honey, you're going to win $500. You're the only girl. Come on, Jennifer. Push. Push, Jennifer.
Darren. Darren says, don't pop out a baby now.
Push, Jennifer. Are you pushing, honey?
Yes, your face is red. Nothing happening, huh?
Mm. Push it. Push it real good. Push your bowels.
I know what you're shooting for.
I want her to grab her pants.
I know you do. Because you know why? Because you're over there.
Yeah. All right, 9-inch nails. This will be your last chance.
This is Chris. All right, Chris from Drexel University, making Drexel proud. Let's see what happens.
Like more people to come. It's Bob.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you ready, Chris?
Who's this?
No, not yet. This is Don and Mike. Who's this?
Oh,
Bob.
Oh, my God. This has got to be the funniest.
Hold on. Here comes Jeremy again.
Hold on. Jeremy's coming back. Hold on.
Oh!
Ow!
We got a horse race.
We sure do. All right, 9-inch nails. Last chance.
This is Chris.
Chris.
I'm sweating. I'm trying so hard.
Yeah, sometimes if you're trying, you know,
it just can't happen.
It really doesn't seem to.
It's a natural thing. And nothing. Jennifer, yeah, but I'll give you one last shot because you're a girl. But pull that microphone down by your mouth. And really, I want to hear the.
I feel so bad for these people because they're going to be driving home and the cars are going to be filled with methane.
All right, Jennifer. No.
Yeah, come on.
Lady. No.
And that is it.
That's it.
Let's congratulate both Joe and Jeremy.
Now we have.
We have
no female winner.
Did anyone have an accident in here? Did you have an accident?
Hold on,
Darren.
Step up. Darren, tell us.
No, Darren, you got to see. No,
hey,
that's
Darren,
not necessary.
Hold on. I will give you a prize. I will give you money if there is a dollop in your underpants.
Oh, God.
Is there a dollop in your underpants?
I feel some wetness about it.
Oh, God.
Go in the production room right now. Take off your pants. Take off your underpants. Put your pants back on. Bring your underpants back.
Oh, God.
Right now.
And, Darren, when you come in, come to the other side of the studio.
I don't mind. Yeah, you come on my side with that. Now, let's see. I'm sorry, Jennifer. There are no winners in the female competition. That means it's Jeremy and Joe.
Jeremy and Joe, yes.
And let's see. I think that it's... Oh, that was Jeremy with another one.
But Jeremy, that's good. Well, it's after the allotted time, but that's not bad.
Okay, now we can vote for... There's both the best male and, also don't forget, most original.
Mm-hmm. Unique.
So yes. there are two categories, and the guys are Jeremy and Joe. Why don't you make your first number for the male competition and the second number for the originality?
Okay.
Okay. And Joe, there you go. There's my numbers, Charlie. You'll add those up. And these, and the usual suspects are voting. It's
is that you? Is that you, dude?
It's me and Mike Buzz and Rob.
Mm-hmm.
Mike, you pass those over.
Thank you, Bob.
And Charlie's gonna go do the math on this.
Cutting the cheese.
Okay.
Party.
And we're going to send him out for a little bit and have him come back in?
No, not yet. I'm waiting for the guy to come back with his underpants. I'll give him $100 if he really has brown.
Here comes Darren right now.
And here he is, Darren.
Right, other side there, buddy.
My side of the microphone. Let me see now. Oh, now he's wearing
the dark
he's
color.
He's wearing blue.
Mm. Hold on. Come over here. Hold it up so Mike can see it.
I saw it already.
Winner. 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 $100 right there.
Way to go.
$100 for crap in your pants.
Wow.
$100.
You can slip those back on. And
hey, hold on a second. Come here. You want to win another $100? Get on this microphone right here, not next to Mike. This one, it's numbered number 4. Microphone number 4. Put your nose right on that and smell it.
$100?
For another $100. Right on the bad spot where all the...
Right there?
The stuff.
Oh,
yep.
Jeez.
Ah!
You did it.
Now.
Oh, my God.
For another $100.
You're going to give me dysentery.
One for three.
Look it.
No!
I got to ask.
$300? All together?
All together.
Why not? I have no shame.
And?
Oh.
Who was that? Was that Joe?
That was Joe.
You ready? All right, hold on. Now he's going to lick it.
$300.
$300.
All right.
Wow.
And it hit him so hard, it knocked a feces out of him.
Wow. Jennifer, would you step up and describe some of what you've seen today? I've seen you recoiling in horror at this.
Well, most of these guys, they're kind of sweaty and holding their stomachs, and especially Joe.
Yes.
And I think he did really well. His parts were pretty good quality.
I agree.
Really, you know, slightly juicy in there.
But you know, my winner right here, Chris, the
Chris.
Guy, not only crapped his pants, took them off, showed them, smelled them, licked them.
I said it was Darren.
Darren, I'm sorry. Yeah, let's give Darren his proper credit.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Sorry, Chris.
And put that band-aid back on, dude.
Now let's wait for the final results to come in.
It just doesn't get any better than this.
Charlie, have you tabulated that yet?
It doesn't get better than this.
Charlie.
Wow.
I'd love to play in the mud because I'm not the fastest guy in the world, but you put us in mud and I'm just as fast as most of the guys. Most guys can't run in mud.
Now, it's a two-horse race here. So, Charlie, we need those results, please.
Here we go.
Hello.
Here are the results, Don.
And the results. Robbie Tiffany, please.
Oh, absolutely.
Let me see. These were judged on both. Well, how do I tell who wins what? Oh, I see. Help me out here, Rob. We got best male fart, and then we have most originality. So that's the winner.
I'm sorry. I just got a lingering effect over here.
I can figure out. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's...
That was
another one from Joe. So is that he'd be the winner for best farting, and he'd be the winner for
original. I don't know how Charlie did.
Charlie, come here. Explain this to me.
Unless these are averages,
just tell me who wins for best farting and who wins. Charlie Broyhill,
Charlie, hurry up!
Look at these. I'm looking at numbers. Looking at the ratings book. I'm seeing 8, 8, 6, 5, 10, 2, 1. Here he is now, Charles Broyhill.
What would you make of how these were written down?
Okay, well, whose is this?
That's Rob.
Rob's? Okay. And mine? Very easy. That's overall, and that one is for
and I know
originality.
That from what?
Because I said, first write overall, then write originality. Oh. All right, just tell us. You did the numbers here. Who is the overall winner?
Joe.
That's a Joe. Good call. That's the way it should be.
$500,
right.
And who wins the $500 for the most original?
You tell me.
Wait, no, you do the numbers here. I think it's Jeremy.
Jeremy's the only other one to produce, and I think he deserves that credit.
Yeah, all right, there you go.
So Jeremy wins, too.
You both win.
There you go.
There you go. And Joe, incidentally, kept farting the whole time.
Through. All the way through. Kept giving.
The whole time. And Darren is the special winner of $300 because Darren...
For the smell taste test.
The nastiest one.
He is sweating like to beat the band.
He went in his pants. He smelled it. It licked it. Wow. You're my hero. And let me say for all of you guys and girls, you've all won 15 Oscar Mayer Big Eats Griller Sausages.
Yay.
Fresh off the grill at 7-Eleven and a 7-Eleven convenient card. Whether you're craving an all-American hot dog or you want to be more adventurous, 7-Eleven has it all. And let me see. Oh, here you go. Also, you're going to go see Meatloaf.
These are all kind of like BM prizes.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, they're good prizes, but they're all related to BM in some way.
You know, Darren looks a little like Meatloaf.
Final night of the 2003 season. Meatloaf performs live in concert at Wolf Trap Sunday, September 7th. For tickets, go to wolftrap.org. So thank you to Jennifer and Jeremy and Chris and Joe and Darren.
Thank you all very much.
All of you, get out of here. Thanks.
Get out of here right away. Hurry up. Come on.
Thank you. And Darren, you made the contest
bye,
for
bye,
me.
Bye-bye, Jennifer. Sorry you didn't produce there for us, Jennifer.
Made the contest for me, Darren.
Hi, guys.
Very, very, Jennifer, very disappointed she wasn't able to.
How about that? Guy Wayne.
And I believe if we, you yesterday had indicated we might have I can't even talk. We might have a category for smell, and I think if that was the case, our friend Jeremy would have won that also.
Yeah, because I got a whiff of that over here, even though you're going real strong with that spray.
But Joe was just producing nonstop, and I feel for the contestants that were trying but weren't able to be successful.
And again, the unsung hero, Darren.
What did he do again, Doc?
He went in his pants.
Say it again.
Then he smelled it.
And he licked it.
And he licked it. Yeah! Yeah! We come back.
It's going to be great for the NBA.
We'll be talking, seriously about Kobe Bryant again when we come right back. Okay? Don't go anywhere.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, we're playing a wacky tape here. I want to thank, what's this guy's name?
Looks like Kurt.
Kurt, who brought in a CD of me. This has to be from maybe 1980.
Ah.
So let's listen.
WPGC.
Let's just do a brief moment. BM.
Before my, so to speak.
Seems accurate, right. Before my.
DC.
Hello, Geronimo.
Hi.
I just wanted to call to tell you I think you're a nice guy, whether you hang up on anybody, brats, or any of your listeners, or anything else.
Oh, thanks.
Because I'll tell you why. I think you have a perfect right, and the police only have a job like you have a job. And if you get bored with the listeners or they get out of line, I think you should hang up on them.
Yeah, you bet.
Just like here in Baltimore. When the police get tired of the public, they go up in the woods and they go to sleep. Okay?
So when I get bored with somebody, I should just hang up on them?
Sure.
Oh.
I'm not proud.
Goodbye.
Is there more?
72, partly cloudy tomorrow, high 83, current Washington temperature 79, another 30-minute sweep of uninterrupted music next. On Geronimo is a copyrighted feature that may not be reproduced except for Lisa Kay.
Yes.
Sitting on the console next to me. Now, Lisa's going to go on an exotic vacation to celebrate our birthdays in about a week.
Oh, God. This would be a horrific DJ crossover.
Oh.
You know, first off, you weren't allowed to stop.
That's not horrific.
You weren't allowed to stop and talk.
Right.
But I'm going to guess it's horrific. I'm just guessing now.
Lisa Kay was the 10 o'clock person?
Yeah. Very great girl. Great girl.
Weeks in Hawaii.
Oh, no, a week. No, absolutely.
DOA?
Yeah. She's like the exception to the rule.
Oh, good.
Beautiful.
In Hawaii, a week in California.
Right.
And to let me have the exotic feel of this vacation.
I wondered if maybe you can watch my guinea pig, Holly.
Watch the guinea pig. Now, she said all the guinea pig does is eat and go to the bathroom.
Well, once in a while, she'll squeak, and she also learned to stand up if you give her lettuce.
If you give her... Now, doesn't this sound exciting, folks? Now, if I had my choice of going to Hawaii or watching Lisa's guinea pig, which eats and goes to the bathroom, I think I would take the second. Now, before we go, the guinea pig impersonation, because Lisa said she can't impersonate her guinea pig.
All right, ready?
Let her rip.
I can't do it anymore.
That's it, huh?
That's the only talent I have.
I lay some newspapers on the floor and a little lettuce. Hey, she's next here at WPGC.
Come on, do it one more time. Lisa's great. All she does is eat and go to the bathroom around here.
Oh, there you go. There's some real talent on display.
She sounded sexy.
Yeah, I was talking about me.
Sometimes the fantasy. My name is Mr. Roar.
Oh, God.
My fine Corinthian leather. It's always been my fantasy to listen to WPGC. All right, Geronimo.
Okay, all right.
making your penis feel young. Don and Mike.
So you said I had no idea that you did a Ricardo Montalban.
Neither did I. Let's do the math. 23 years ago.
I enjoyed that DJ crossover though with Lisa Kay. Is she still in the business?
Don't know, Mike. But you know what? She'd make a perfect Mrs. Mike O'Hara.
I mean, she was a cutie pie.
Really? She was. And a real nice girl. Real nice.
I like the guinea pig impression. That some, since you painted the picture of her being a hottie, it was kind of sexy hearing that.
And, like, that's the type of thing that back in the day you'd do it in the program director would call.
Hello?
Hey, hola. Is mom there?
No, she's out with the dogs.
Oh, all right. Well, never mind. I'll talk to her later.
Okay, then.
All right, love you. See you.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. That's the type of thing that you would do that, and then you'd hang the phone up because you do the bit, you take your headphones off, and the light would be ringing, and it would be dumb Steve Kushner calling going, do you realize, you know, or he's doing his hushed tones.
Do you realize you just talked for 1 minute and 18 seconds with no music?
You know, and you'd be sitting there going, come on, we're DJs. We're trying to have some fun.
Oh, man.
Anyways.
And DJ crossovers are great. I've always enjoyed them.
Anyway, thank you, Kurt. Rob will go through that and find the most embarrassing moments.
It would be a lot of fun if you could do a crossover with O'Reilly every day.
Now the...
and keep the Ricardo Montalban, please.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you said keep only the most embarrassing moments.
Yeah, I know. Now that's just a lead into this next segment. Next to myself, I think the person I most admire in the world is Brian Wilson. Now, you know I love Brian Wilson. I really do. Mm-hmm. And I get into real arguments with Rob, like about who's more influential, Elvis or Brian Wilson.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I've always maintained that Brian's my man, even though he's effed up and he's got a head full of all kinds of God knows what.
Don Beethoven was effed up.
Mm-hmm. He was.
He was deaf.
And that's part of my argument, is that, 100 years from now, they're going to say Brian Wilson is the Beethoven of this generation.
Right.
My son found this tape of Brian Wilson before he had his strokes. So this is Brian Wilson.
This is young. Is somebody breaking wind in here again, or is that just the lingering? Did somebody throw something
it's
away?
It's residue. This is Brian Wilson, circa 1970. Okay. Okay, so just 3 years off.
This is before the Sandbox.
Yes, well, no, this is post-Sandbox, but just 3 years past the success of Good Vibrations.
So he still kind of was out there performing.
Yes, he's still...
But he wasn't at that carry-him-up-the-stage thing that I saw him.
No, he still occasionally would broadcast, go out on concert with the Beach Boys and would occasionally appear on their records.
Okay.
He was at Ringo Starr's birthday party. And at one point they said, hey, get up and sing Good Vibrations. Ringo loves that song.
Right.
Because the Beatles were still happening. Here now is my idol, Brian Wilson.
Where's that beats? Bum. Hey, yeah. Give your hands together for Brian Wilson. Oh, Brian, life can be better.
Hello. Hi, Brian.
Hello.
You know you're my idol.
How?
You must have been at Van Dyke Parks. Van Dyke Parks is the biggest butthole. The biggest butthole in the world. Hey, Malvo. I can't help you with that.
You want to play them keyboards, bro?
Hey.
Don't you hear it? It's very Elvis-y.
Whoa.
You said worse than Elvis.
One for the TV, one for two, or one for the money, one for the power to the
Wow. Trying to do Barbara Ann.
What was that beginning?
I have no idea.
Everybody.
seconds from the vomitorium.
Keep that on file the next time I go into one of my long diatribes about what a genius it got.
Barbara, give me send me to Baba.
Which wow. is more embarrassing, my tape or his tape?
Oh, I think he laughed you on that
yeah.
one.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you. I was looking, I tossed you that softball.
Oh, it was... But you know what? Even embarrassing, but in a fun way. I mean, after it all, it is Brian Wilson. He was probably, as much as it's strange to say, more together back in that era than he was when I saw him when you hosted the party on the 4th on the mall. Where,
oh, my God, yeah.
Where I was backstage,
my God.
And watched him. It's one of the most amazing things I've ever seen, watching a guy be physically carried up the stairs to the stage.
Wow.
And then... As we discussed, he had his keyboard unplugged.
His electric piano was unplugged.
Because he was just going, bzz, 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 bzz.
Yeah.
That's back when he was in his home. Yeah, then he became the guy from
Caddyshack.
Yeah. Right there. That's his llama.
Anyway, there he is, my hero, Brian.
I agree. He's a genius.
Yeah. Performing for equally talented and genius like Ringo Starr. Jesus Christ. Hello, Dynamite.
Hey, Don.
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing? This is John from Ocean City.
Hi, John.
When I heard that PGC tape, I swear I'm dating myself, but I think remember that voice, really. Do you remember your only competition, I think, back in PGC at that day was, remember a guy named Barry Richards?
No. My competition was a fat guy named Uncle Johnny.
Uncle Johnny.
When I came to...
And his tight Kiana shirts at Q107.
When I came to town, Uncle Johnny had a 25 share. And when I left town, Uncle Johnny was out of town.
Yeah, wow. That's right.
Yeah, I was just curious.
How sad it is that I remember that, you know, 23 years later.
Johnny, when I came down to this area, was,
Uncle Johnny.
It was the beginning of the end.
And Uncle Johnny, his whole thing was, hey, you're listening to Uncle Johnny on Q107. Hey, how are you, Q107?
Hey, Uncle Johnny with you? Yeah, Q107, yeah, here we go.
I know this recalls a cartoon that Mike had on his refrigerator for a long time, but Uncle Johnny was the first disc jockey I ever saw.
Yeah, the cartoon that I have on my refrigerator is a kid that's sitting there with his head in his hands sobbing in the caption. Mother standing next to him, and the caption is, "Don't worry, son, I remember when I saw my first disc jockey."
He's a horrifying individual to see.
Hello, Don and Mike.
Hey, Don and Mike, how you guys doing?
We're doing great.
Sounded a lot like crap on a late Friday night, Mike's band.
No, he's joking, but I swear to God, we've had third set. Usually my fault, too. Only if I'm singing, though, sir.
Okay. So are you the...
And the Lord said... Let there be crap.
Are you Brian Wilson-ish?
No. Because I don't sing. But I'll tell you, my right foot tends to go into Brian Wilson. If you want to have fun, come out to one of our gigs. And if I've had a few cocktails, listen to my right foot. Listen to the bass pedal on the drums, because it'll be going like this. The song will have this beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. And on the bass drum, you'll hear this. That's my right foot just flopping around.
All right, thank you. We got a break. You know, someone we've not talked to all this week. We're going to have him on next. And just let me say, oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
It's been a long time. It's been 3 or 4 days since we've done this bit. We'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
We'll give you an eye-opening personality profile absolutely free. This $40 value will get you started.
Loser. You've heard a lot of talk about Singular Wireless for quite some long time now. Now hear this.
Let me tell you something, Don.
Yeah, Mike?
I bought my mom a Singular Wireless phone and got her on that Singular Wireless plan.
Did you?
And she just can't stop talking about it. She absolutely loves it. She says it's the best phone and the best phone service that she's ever had.
Yo, check it. Singular's offering a Motorola V60 phone free after a $50 mail-in rebate and a $50 trade-in with a 2-year service agreement.
Yo, dog. Singular has family talk. Add a line for just $9.99 per line per month on select plans. It'll start at $39.99 a month. And you can share your minutes. Bob Ram, Bob Ram. Nationwide with no long-distance charges.
I heard Brian Wilson has his phone with Singular.
He does. He loves it. He bought one for his mom.
That's what I heard. Certain restrictions apply. See any Singular wireless store for details.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
What they can expect from Jingle All the Way is a hilarious movie, a movie where they will be able to laugh from the beginning to the end. It will be great entertainment. They will walk out of the theater and say, I am so angry that I can't get another ticket right away because I want to see you the second time. And there's a long line here.
Creating their legacy, Don and Mike.
And this is Friday. We're giving away a trip or two to Phoenix. See WWE SummerSlam. Don't miss WWE SummerSlam live August 24 on in-demand pay-per-view. Call Comcast or Cox Cable. Now to order. Digital customers, enjoy easy ordering.
Yeah.
Using your digital remote. Okay. We just got something, and the header is Gannett, which is the company that owns USA Today.
Yes.
We have a guy. It says, Dear Don and Mike, here's a preview of Craig Wilson's column tomorrow in USA Today.
Bring it.
Please be careful to say not where this came from. I don't want to lose my job.
Sure.
Well, tough. I said Gannett, but I'm not mentioning any names.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll check it out in tomorrow's paper. Final word, it's August. And everyone I know is on vacation. And anyway, according to this, the guy who works, as you can see, Gannett, the crux of the article tomorrow will be 1,000 places to see before you die.
Hmm.
So we'll find out if we have a mole inside the USA building. And
very exciting. That's cool.
On tomorrow's episode. Now, Arnold Schwarzenegger is all over the place.
I can't get away from the press. Who wants to, you know, find out exactly what, you know, what I'm going to do with the upcoming election. I'm the popular guy and the candidate, and, you know, you'll find out like everybody else. I can't say what I'm going to do with my future plans, but excuse me, my future plans. But I call this the danger zone.
Now you're going on Jay Leno tomorrow night.
That's the only place to go.
Why is that?
That's where I got treated the best. And he's the funniest guy. He's the great comedian that has all the lines that are so funny. And I think that what I'm going to do is basically talk to Jay about all those great comedy bits that he's done about me. You know, INJ is loosely based on Arnold, and that's okay. And let's not forget the bright colors. That show's so exciting with all the bright things coming out and the music and the lights up on top and the people scream. And the best thing is Jay's such a good guy that he'll walk down to the audience and shake their hands on certain audience members.
You know, a lot of us find that as a dividing line as to someone's intellect.
I like, you know, dancing Edos, too. Japanese people.
If you watch Nightline, if you watch...
Oh, that show sucks.
If you watch Letterman...
That's Letterman's angry and not funny. Leno's really a good guy.
Then you're on one side. If you watch... And even if you watch Jimmy Kimmel, you'd be kind of...
He doesn't matter. I think it's important for me to go on the show that's got the brightest audience and the people that are the smartest, and that's why I've selected Jay to, you know, have me on when I make the explanation of the governor's decision that I'm going to make.
I understand that we've run this thing with you calling people who are dead into the ground.
Yeah, bro.
But you're going to call someone today for advice.
Yeah.
About making this important announcement.
That's right. It's really important. Who am I going to call for the advice? I've completely forgotten. I guess we talked about who.
Let me turn the mic.
Hold on a second. I have to have a private chat.
Hold on.
Hold on a second. I'll make the call. Here we go. Thanks, boys.
I know we had talked about this.
Let's call right now. Because this is, in my humble opinion, the greatest American politician in the history of the United
States. And this is not going to be one of those, oh, my God, he's dead calls.
Nope. Okay. Nope. Are we going to dial?
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Let's go. Sorry, that's my fault. Where's the phone? I got the personal number. Let's see.
And you're going to be getting... Now, I got to take the off here after it rings.
You going to ring?
Oh, there you go. Right.
Hello? Nancy Reagan?
Oh, no.
Hi. Yeah, it's Arnold Schwarzenegger. Oh. Yes. Well, Dankeschön. Thank you. I'm glad you have. You're a fan. I really thank you. Yes, it was good working at the White House with the president's physical fitness thing. Listen, I don't have much time. I have to share something with you right now. I'm running for the governorship of California, and I really want you to do me a favor. Could you ask your husband, Ronald Reagan, if he could give me some pointers? I could talk to him right now, and he could give me some pointers on the speech that I'm going to make to kick off my campaign. He's the great speech maker. They called him the great communicator, and I think it's really... It's what? I just had a couple of questions that... He... Oh. You mean now? Oh, my God. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, the brain thing. Yeah. Oh, that's sad. So he can't talk? Okay, I'm sorry. Hey, Nancy, I'm really sorry I bothered you. Yeah, I'm real sorry. Okay, that's it. I'll talk to you later. I'll be the same.
He's got that brain thing.
Who does?
Alzheimer. That thing where he can't talk, and she thought I knew, and I didn't know. Oh, my God.
You know,
that's just such a terrible thing.
You just discovered that Ronald Reagan has Alzheimer's?
Yeah, that's the thing. That's what he's got. That's where he couldn't talk to me and give me advice.
That's
so depressing. Oh, my God.
Maybe you shouldn't go into the political ranks. Maybe you should look into your Rolodex to see if you can find anybody in the world of entertainment who can help you.
Oh, I know a bunch of people.
All right.
Like some of these.
But again, not someone who's dead.
Please. Right. Okay.
All right.
This guy's... They don't get any hotter than this. This will be a real coup, because I know all these guys, but I know the biggest popular one right now.
Because we've run this whole
thing... This will
thing,
be great.
We've run this whole he's dead, oh my God thing into the ground.
Yeah, I don't even need money. I'll give you some endorsement.
All
an endorsement for...
There you go.
Hello. Yes, Mrs. Bryan.
Oh, no.
Yeah, this is Arnold Schwarzenegger. Hi. Oh, you recognize the voice. Good. How are you doing? That's great. Hey, listen, you might remember that in the press they had the stories about me running for governor, and they're looking for major celebrities and athletes to endorse my campaign. And I'm wondering if your husband, Kobe, would be available to give me an endorsement for the campaign. He would? Oh, that's good. Would you put him on the phone? Great. He said, she said he'd do it without any problem.
See, now you're not getting the standard, you know, he's dead bit.
This is encouraging.
Hey, Kobe! It's Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yeah, how are you? Oh, really? Yeah, listen, I'm running for the governor of California, and I'm wondering if there's a chance that you could endorse my campaign. You'd love to, but... You'd love to... You're doing... Trial? She's rape? Oh, my God.
Really?
I had no idea. Oh, I'm so sorry. Well, Kobe, I don't think it would be a good idea for you to endorse the campaign with all that going on. You understand me, right? Oh, my God. Hey, good luck. Goodbye. He raped somebody. Oh, my God.
Breaking news.
That's not good. I can't be associated with that. You know, I always had that track record from the pumping iron with the girls that I was involved with. It was very, very painful. That's such a drag.
Come back on the show tomorrow. And,
oh, my God.
What we'll do is we will prep you for your appearance with Jay Leno.
He said he's going to be on trial.
Yes, it's going to be on TV tomorrow.
Oh, my God, that's so bad.
You didn't know that?
That's bad news.
Yeah.
That's the first you've heard?
He was a good guy. Man, that's a drag. Wow. You can't call anybody in California and get endorsements or money anymore. Hey, they're either dead or in trouble. Or they have Alzheimer's disease.
Hey, Arnold, when you were boy, growing up, a little boy there in Austria,
yes.
What did you like to spread on your toast or your bread in the morning?
Nutella. I loved it. Nutella was great.
Hey, didn't you call it Nutella?
No, the only guys that did that, that pronounced it that way were French. It was silly. Hey, are we having a good time?
In a world where owning a radio was strictly forbidden, one man found a way to bring good news to his people.
Buzz.
He made it up.
Hi, Buzz.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your story today, Buzz?
How are you? What is it, Buzz?
I'm out today, Arnold. Ben and Jen are apparently not through releasing bad movies.
Oh, man, she's crazy, that one.
Mm-hmm.
Jen and Ben, he's the actor.
Yes.
Yeah. What's with them?
I don't know. They make bad movies.
Are they together?
Yeah. Yeah, well, that's the story.
Oh, my God.
Stay tuned for news and comment coming up on the Don and Mike Show.
You didn't know that she was going out with Ben Affleck?
Oh, no, I thought it was Minnie Driver.
Okay, that was very...
Of the same professional.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
What's the word from Planet Crapbot?
The Don and Mike Show.
Come and taste their friendship. The Don and Mike Show.
Yeah, time for Buzz Girdley now, and Buzz is brought to you by Veramax Sexual Pleasure and Performance Enhancer. 35,000 retail locations.
Someone call for a doctor.
New double strength Veramax Ultra. Get it now by calling 1-888-TRI-VMAX. That's 1-888-TRI-VMAX. But I would never stop talking here. That's where the program director would say, shut up.
Right.
And I'd say in my head, but all they're doing is going, do, 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 do.
Right.
And then you go, here's Kiss on KFI.
Yeah.
I want to give it all.
Damn, I love Kiss.
Stay tuned for Lisa K coming up.
Hot Lisa K.
And Buzz, we're going to give you a full 15-minute segment here.
Cool.
My wife's not there. Screw it. Move on. Just I want to give Mike the clarification.
Well, you know, I like that. Because, I mean, I've had that woman on the brain since you talked about her a little bit.
We played the tape about an hour ago. Hey, is Mom back yet?
What?
Is your mother back yet?
Yeah, and then she went to the store.
Oh, okay. I'll call her in the car. Love you. See ya. Bye. Did she look anything like her sister, Ellen?
Who?
Yeah. Ellen K.
Yeah. No, they look like their father a little bit.
Ernie Kenny.
Ernie Kenny.
Her aunt. Mary.
Who?
Mary.
Mary very quickly, I want to tell you, somebody sent in a real high-quality CD of me on WPGC from, I don't know, like right before we married, like 1980, 1981. And
yeah.
I'm doing a crossover with Lisa Kay.
Uh-huh.
Remember her?
Sure.
And Mike was asking me if Lisa Kay, off the air, Mike was saying, was she a pig? And I was saying that Lisa Kay was an attractive girl who was a good friend of mine and a friend of yours. Will you back it up that Lisa Kay wasn't a pig?
No, I think I remember. I barely remember. She was more a friend of yours, but I remember being jealous, so she must have been cute.
There you go.
There's
confirmation.
All right, baby.
All right, sweet pea.
Hey, 2 days until we prove them all wrong again.
I know. We're hanging in there.
2 days until we get to call your sister up.
Okay, you only mildly pissed me off today, so you're doing good.
How did I mildly piss you off today?
I'm just not getting the car taken care of, but you're doing that, so you're doing good.
All right, baby. Oh, that was not a radio thing.
No, that's
a real life thing.
Yeah.
All right. All right, love you.
Love you, sweetie.
Bye, baby.
Bye.
All is right with the world.
In just 2 days, she and I will have been shackled together for 22 years.
Congratulations.
Yeah. 22 million years.
Yeah, you know, it's a hell of an accomplishment.
22 billion years. 22, I don't know what's bigger than billion.
Trillion.
Hi, Buzz.
Hi, Don and Mike.
Hi there.
Fresh off bad reviews for Geely, comes word that Ben and J-Lo's next movie also stinks. An audience member who's seen an advanced screening of Jersey Girl says people started walking out almost as soon as the movie started.
Now, listen, here's the thing. That this is a Kevin Smith production.
Yeah.
And generally speaking, I find Kevin Smith to be funny, witty, cutting edge, even with J-Lo, I can't think the movie really stinks on ice. And it's got...
Is he your dogma guy?
Yeah.
Kevin Smith?
Yeah. And it's got, what's his name, the boyfriend, Matt Damon in it.
Oh, it's got Matt Damon in it,
yeah.
Too. Well, there's a little too much friendliness. You know what I mean? You bring in actors that don't know each other, you probably do better.
Well, quoting the previewer, unless the cutting room floor contains a pile over 10 feet high, I don't think there's any way to save this movie. But Jersey Girl director Kevin Smith is comparing critics of Geely to the Columbine killers. Quoting him, the naked aggression is astounding. All right, folks are tired of hearing about their relationship, but who started covering it in the first place? The same press that's going after them. Ben and Jen got what they wanted out of it. What? Ben and Jen. End quote. What?
You know, and I watched trailers in the movies last night, and I've rarely seen trailers for every movie that looks like I might enjoy it. There's a movie with Michael Caine and Robert Duvall playing these old guys.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's this...
It looks pretty good.
Oh, the Adlibs look like
right.
Could be okay. Here's where we're going to fire company. The one with Russell Crowe on the high seas playing the... did you see the trailer for that one?
Snore.
It looks like it'd be pretty cool. I like anything with the ocean. And then the other one is your man Clooney with... Catherine Zeta-Jones, that just looks like,
that's
based
winner.
On their heat alone, yeah, it's going to be a big hit.
That is a winner. And this worries me that Kevin Smith is defending Giggly.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I know he's friends with Ben Affleck and everything, but, you know, hey, Kevin, listen, and I'm nothing more than a mega fan, stay the F away from Giggly.
And don't you think, really, if they had managed to make decent movies, it would keep going? I mean, if these movies were decent flicks...
Right. They'd be a team.
I think they'd be like, everybody would be talking about Tracy Hepburn and stuff like that.
If people went to see Made in Manhattan, okay?
Mm-hmm. Right.
That movie's a total piece of dog ass.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is, like I said yesterday, there's too much of them, together,
right.
Being happy, being in love. For all I know, Giggly is a good movie. People just are in the mood to hate them.
Well, I'll tell you, that George Clooney, Catherine Zeta-Jones movie. Man, oh man, I was thinking one thing, you know, that Michael Douglas must be looking over his shoulder a little bit.
Oh, he's got to be ordering Viagra on the internet from Canada.
She looks good with Clooney, man. I mean, she looks like she belongs with Clooney. She really does.
Well, Ben is
so hot.
Ben, and he's so handsome. I'll say it, I don't care.
She looks awesome. I mean, she looks better than she's ever looked.
Yeah, I agree.
So does he.
Well, Ben and J-Lo are still an item, despite the recent tabloid story about Ben's trip to a strip club. Ben still denies the story, but the Inquirer says it has the nightclub security video.
She was a whore.
And it's challenging Ben to take a lie detector test the way its sources did. No response from Affleck's people, but a friend of J-Lo says, quote, she doesn't give an F about the story. She thinks it's funny. The wedding is still on. End quote.
You know that's not true.
I was reading something in, I guess, the New York Post on Sunday, an interview with her old husband, her second husband, the guy who looks like a Buddhist monk, the guy Chris's his first name.
Mm-hmm. Judd.
Yes. The guy got a shaved head. He's wearing like a Nehru thing.
Right.
And he was saying, yeah, Chris Judd, he's saying he's still terribly in love with her.
Yeah.
You know, someone should just slap that boy and say, listen, be glad that that white ass has moved on to the next man.
Sometimes women can dump guys and, you know, they just stay in love with them. It's amazing. It's true.
All of those guys need to be slapped, Mike. Thank you.
Here.
Hey, come on. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't want to be the one to slap you.
Don't slap me.
You're my buddy.
Give me a while before you slap me. You know.
Hey, bud, slap.
Let me.
I can't do this. I got a partnership going.
I can't understand. Whatever.
You know. Listen.
What?
Ever. I think you're going to get your noodle wet very soon.
It's not a question of...
Based on the, I know it's not, but that's how I gauge your mood. Based on the fact that last night you thought Seabiscuit sucked.
Oh, that's a good sign?
Your balls got a little bigger last night.
All right. Okay, good.
Good.
All right.
Now you just got to get someone to take care of those balls.
You know what I watched this morning?
What?
Avalon.
Oh. Faggot.
I love it. Cried like a baby.
Are you kidding?
No, I watched Avalon today. I really did.
And you cried?
No.
Okay, good. Did you really?
No.
Be honest.
No, it has a couple of moments that are emotional for me, yes. The movie touches me on a very deep level.
Get out, man.
What?
Play golf.
I haven't been.
Play golf.
You can reach me all the time lately?
Yeah, I know.
Have you noticed that? Normally when you'd be, you call me on my cell and I'm home.
I know.
I'm home, but you know, I'm playing The Getaway, though. So that's good.
Well, you're playing The Getaway.
The greatest video game
the video
ever made.
Oh.
The PlayStation 2. It's fantastic.
Mm-hmm. See, now if you...
Do you know how many murders I've committed in The Getaway, really conservatively? Probably 150.
The only Avalon that you are allowed to cry about is Frankie Avalon.
I've never shed a tear for that guy.
Don't like him.
But it's Ben Affleck and Matt Damon who are the subject of a new off-Broadway play. Matt and Ben was written by and stars two young women who play the movie-making buddies. Every word of the play is fiction, but the women did their research in great detail.
Oh, God.
Their story has the boys competing for a lead role, but it's not a mean-spirited script.
Project Poonlight.
It does suggest that Ben is the less brainy of the two. In the play, his character uses the word chillaxin because he senses something missing in just chilling or relaxing. What do the real Ben and Matt think about it? Well, quoting one of the play's authors, we haven't gotten any feedback from them. We haven't been too worried about whether they like it or hate it.
Now here's what I picture is going on right now at Matt Damon's house. What was I watching today for a couple minutes? The Bourne Identity.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty decent movie.
I want to see that.
Matt Damon's got a pretty happening little career happening.
Mm-hmm.
So here's what I imagine has been happening the last 3 or 4 days. Matt Damon sitting at home, having a drink. You know, getting his jerk on, being his girlfriend, watching the Red Sox, whatever you're doing.
Right.
And Robbie, give me you got the phone sound effect?
Yeah.
And so he's just sitting around, I'm Matt Damon, I'm getting ready to do the Bourne Identity too. No way I'm picking that up. No way. Let me check the caller ID.
Is it him?
It's him. Let the machine get it. And here I goes.
Hi, this is Matt Damon. I'm not here. Leave the message at the tone.
Matt, it's Ben. Please remember Goodwill Hunting. Please.
Slap me.
Click.
Yep.
As we mentioned in passing the other day, Hustler publisher Larry Flint is running for governor in California.
I just think that I'm going to make the state of California better.
Why?
More porno. More dance clubs. Adult bookstores, swingers, clubs, and the like.
Well, he says he can balance the state's unstable budget better than, quote, those pinhead bureaucrats in Sacramento.
I can balance the budget more than those pinheads in Sacramento.
Yeah, the only bad thing about that job, Larry, is you have to live in Sacramento.
You know how I know there are pinheads in Sacramento?
Yeah.
I listen to your show.
Larry Flint has chosen as his slogan, vote for a smut peddler who cares.
Will you do the Sacramento dance from your wheelchair?
I can't. I can make my hand. Watch this. I'll just use my hands, though, okay?
Yeah.
I licked my nipple. I'm Larry Flint.
Flint's priorities are education and immigration, he says. He wants the state's borders sealed because he says the feds are doing a lousy job. As for the money crisis, he's suggesting that private casinos be allowed to have slot machines to be taxed by the state. He says he doesn't have a penny of special interest money behind him, quoting him, "I don't owe anybody anything." To which he adds, "Just because I publish porn doesn't mean I'm not concerned about social ills."
The only thing I have in back of me is my poop bag. I got a poop bag.
You got your PB.
Got my poop bag. Yeah, and I'll throw it on anybody that doesn't vote for me.
Oh, dear. It's a fanny bag.
It's a fanny bag here. Want to see?
No.
Okay.
I already saw a guy today take off his underpants and stuff and then smell it and lick it.
Yeah, Darren's a good boy.
You going to put him in your magazine?
Yes, I am. And he'll be part of my campaign.
Well, maybe Don and Mike can console the Pope. The Pontiff has just lost one of his best affiliates. The city of Rome has ordered off the air a one-man TV station that covered the Pope's every move. The city says it did this out of concern about the electronic waves from the TV's broadcast tower. The waves seem to be permeating a school full of children. But the broadcaster says he'll fight to get back on the air, quoting him, "The word of God cannot be chained."
What did you shut it down for?
There's some crap about the radiating kids.
What do you think about that?
F them. I'm the Pope.
How's it going, Your Holiness?
I do the show like Regis and Kathy Lee.
Yeah, are you going to do that on that radio station?
I come out every morning, I say, "Hey, it's the Pope." I look at the paper, I talk about the teams.
Do you have a sidekick like Kelly Lee?
Oh, I do. What's her name? She was in Showgirls.
Elizabeth Hurley?
Elizabeth. Yeah, Elizabeth Hurley.
That's right. Wow. But you like Elizabeth. You tried to get Elizabeth Hurley, didn't you?
Yeah, I got her. I can get her. And then I say two things. I says, "Yeah, who are you?"
You're His Holiness the Pope.
I say, "First, remember, the Catholic Church says God hates fags." And then I said, "As far as this radiation, let the little pricks glow in the dark." Until next time, this is the Pope. Peace out.
His Holiness.
Good job, Paul. Peace out.
What do you like in the Thursday game?
Take the Giants and the points. And incidentally, That's bull ass what happened last night.
Yeah, you didn't like that when they called that game. Well, couldn't you have avoided that electrical storm by talking to the big guy?
He had a fight with someone.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. I understand.
Then how am I supposed to know? Hold on.
Hello?
Hello, guys.
Tom, you're on with the Pope.
Hey, Mr. Pope.
Hello, Tom.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Anything you'd like to say to the Pope, Tom?
Hey, Pope, why don't you go back to Ireland?
He doesn't live in Ireland, Tom.
Why would I go to Ireland? I'm a Polack.
You're a Polack?
Tom, would you like to ask any questions of the Pope?
Where do you live at, Mr. Pope?
I live at the Vatican.
You live in the Vatican?
Can you spell Vatican, Tom?
The Vatican? V-I-N-G-E-N.
Zingen.
Hey, Mike?
Yes, Tom?
Where's Charlie?
Charlie's not here. You're speaking with the Pope.
Hey,
He just came in. It's Satan, Tom.
Hey, Satan!
You hate Satan, don't you, Tom?
Yes!
I am the god of hellfire! I'm gonna bring you fire!
How you doing, my returning little puppet?
Hey, let me help!
Tom, you know, he only responds to you when you're really mean to him, and I mean, be as mean as you can be.
Son of a bitch, get
out of
here!
How you doing, my returning little puppet boy?
You gotta be...
Sucker, you get out of the way!
No, you gotta be meaner than that, Tom. No, mean words, Tom. The meanest words you can come up with.
Be mean to me. No, come on. Be mean to me. Like the way your mom treated me. Hello, the little retarded muppet.
He's gone. Tom, you got to say mean words to him. Mean words.
Hey, God's reject. Is that the best you can do?
What?
Tom, you're not using bad words. That's all you're saying. He said S-word twice. Yeah, he did.
I didn't get the
Quiet. Nope, someone upstairs did.
I'm sure they did.
All right, Tom, till next time, this is Satan saying, I'll see you in hell.
Hey, Shaken.
Yeah, Tom.
Hey, I'm coming in on, like, probably Friday, if I can come in.
No, Don and Mike never want you to come in the studio.
I'm coming in the studio on Friday.
Don't. Come on Saturday.
No, Friday.
Come on Saturday.
Friday!
Saturday, damn it. On Saturday.
Shut up!
They're having a special show for people that God has punished.
Harry?
Oh, God.
My pardon.
Shut up! No, I'm...
I'm not nuts.
You are.
My douche.
You shut up!
My low IQ.
No, you.
My paint chips.
My jackass.
Children of the men are mine.
Shut up, jackass.
Your mother had a tail.
Shut up, jackass.
Your mother had horns.
Shut up, jackass.
I am your father, Tom.
I am on the world of fire.
Tom.
Yes.
You don't know how to talk to Satan.
Satan.
I am the god of hellfire, and I bring you fire.
Yes. You're way too nice to him, Tom.
What, Tom?
Hey, Satan.
What?
Shut up and go back to hell.
No, that's not just way too nice.
You know what you are? You're a sweaty little irregular mistake, and I have no more time for you. I say good day to you.
Shut up, you.
I
get up.
Good day to you.
No, he just doesn't do it. Doesn't step it up.
That's tough when Tom won't say the F-bomb to Satan.
I know he won't.
That's why I don't like any of those people down here. Let him have them.
Is Tom still on the line?
Tom?
He's
retarded.
He's gone.
I'm out of here, too.
And all you wanted Satan to do, I mean, all you wanted Tom to do...
Drop the F-bomb.
That's right.
Hey, everybody, go see Seabiscuit. Good luck with Dr. Natasha Terry.
Okay, that's it.
Man.
Be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Gosh, I hate to interrupt. It's all been so incredibly fascinating and entertaining and instructive. Really, the time has just flown by.
The Don and Mike Show. Always the exception to every rule ever made. Don Geronimo and Michael Mara.
He's all an executive here. Don.
Hey.
And Mike.
Hi, Alan.
You know, you never came in today.
Yeah.
To tap me on the shoulder about that thing.
You know what Charlie was supposed to do? And you were in the midst of... you were not on a break when I popped by and Charlie did it.
Oh, all right. Well, go ahead. Announce it, Alan.
Oh, you mean I'm on the air?
Yes.
Yeah.
Charlie just tapped
that down on the shoulder.
Oh,
Alan has a major announcement.
We have a timpani for it?
Oh, I'll get the timpani.
Would
Hold
you
on.
Please?
Yeah. A major announcement from Infinity Broadcasting that I believe is going to rock the industry and the radio world.
Huge.
Ladies and gentlemen, effective immediately, the new vice president and general manager of WJFK FM is Ken Stevens.
Wow. This man is lying.
Hi, Al.
Hey. How you doing? I'm doing fine. No.
And now, here with a major announcement, is acting WJFK Vice President and Manager Alan Linewan.
Go ahead, Al.
Spoken like a true announcer. I just want to make an announcement that the technology world has hit WJFK today. And effective right now, I mean right this moment, we have an all-new WJFK website.
Wow!
Now, here's
the matter of fact, this is not a joke.
Wow! Here is the website. And let me just be the first to say, everybody, welcome to the 90s.
Yep.
The website is www.pickupapenny.com. No, it's www.1067wjfk.com. And, of course, because we're Infinity, you know, as I was discussing with Alan before the show, it's very pretty, but you can't hear the radio station on it. We don't stream. But we do have...
We stream, though.
For instance, we do have pictures up of today's contestants at the barbecue,
baked
bean contest.
Right.
106.7 WJFK. Everybody now is writing the ad-libs. Boldly stepping into the 90s.
Uh-huh.
WJFK.
That would be the 1890s.
And you'll see, let me see, there's a Don and Mike page there. And there's,
that's nice.
Let me see, let me click back here for a second. There's a poll.
A poll, what, like a dancer's poll?
No, it's a pollock.
What's the poll question today?
I'm trying to... Well, now it's flooded, Mike.
Oh, now it's crashing.
I think you've now probably crashed the site.
Now it's flooded. Hold on. It won't go back.
I couldn't be any more excited, Alan.
I know, but it was up for almost 10 minutes.
Now, hold on. I'm going back to the homepage now. It's just taking a while to load. Now, I don't know if it's volume or if it's just our crappy computers you supply.
No, I think it's volume. I fully expected the moment you announced it, Don, it would be flooded.
Excuse me, let me just tell everybody, it's very pretty, but as I was telling Alan, the problem now is coming up with content.
Yeah.
That it's pretty, but once you get past the fact that it has the NASCAR cars going past real fast, and the Redskins helmet, and it's got the logo with like lightning bolts coming out of it, once you get past that, well, it's up to the guys and gals on the third floor to make it a great...
Make it sing, guys. Make it sing.
We've got a crack staff involved in this right now, so I think it's going to be terrific.
And they're all on crack. Now, let me see. Hold on. I'm going to click back on where it says Don and Mike.
Yes.
And I'll tell you our poll question. Well, I would tell you if the page was...
Oh, here it's loading. Comes.
Here it's loading right
we
now.
We got it.
Photo galleries, promotions, contest.
Mm-hmm.
Poll question.
WJFK, you're home with the Redskins.
Yes.
You got a nice banner ad on the bottom, Al. Good job. I'm still waiting for it to load.
Could it be our computer?
It's probably your computer.
But the logo is going crazy. The logo is like nuts like this.
Isn't that great? Isn't that wonderful?
The logo is like going upside down.
It's
and
like Frankenstein lightning bolts going in and out of it. It's
and actually, there's audio to it as well. I don't know if you could turn it up. But there's...
Yeah, it's got that voice guy you're getting rid of.
That's right. I had to think about that for a second. You're right.
Yeah, he's on there.
Well, where's the poll question?
Well, I can't pull it up. Buzz, go there and see if you can do it. Go to 1067wjfk.com.
Well, I've shut down my computer. Let me see what I can
do. Well, never mind then, Buzz. Never mind. But don't bother restarting.
I think I remember the poll question.
All right. Well,
Buzz is in his car already.
If you see a penny... No, I'm kidding.
Stop it. It has something to do with who's the hottest Jennifer.
Oh, okay.
It was like J-Lo or Jennifer Gardner or Jennifer Aniston.
Oh,
that's what the poll question was.
Good. Love Hewitt.
Yeah. I think that was it. So anyway, Alan wanted us to announce that, and it's actually very nice looking.
Mm-hmm.
Trust me, you're going to want to look at it for maybe 40 seconds.
What is the address again?
1067WJFK.com.
Very exciting.
You know, I'm going to say that you're going to get tops 75 seconds of internet excitement.
You can get a lot of excitement in 75 seconds.
From this website right here. And this comes from the radio station that's never had a website.
Yeah.
We're very excited about it.
Good first step, Al.
Well, you know, we were waiting for the internet to catch on. We figured about time.
Seriously, on behalf of everybody listening and everybody here, what the frig is it going to take? You know, we're in bed with AOL, for God's sakes. We run commercials for AOL. What's it going to take to get the show on the internet? Alan?
Oh, I thought that was rhetorical.
No, that was an actual question.
That was an actual question.
And I'm even reading somewhere the Cheap Channel is actually charging people now to listen to their show.
But, you know, there may be a change in philosophy. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Let's keep it at that.
Okay.
All right, Alan. All right, thank you.
Hey, guys, I appreciate it. Thank you, and thanks for flooding the website.
Well, our pleasure. No, you did the flooding, Al.
Have fun with it.
You did the flooding. Bye-bye.
Enjoy.
Bye, Alan.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Sleep well.
I'm sorry, did you say something, Mike?
No, that was Rob, Alan.
Bye.
I think Rob said that he was going to meet you later tonight on Penny Lane.
Okay, I can't hear you.
All right. Bye. Bye-bye.
There he goes, Alan Limewine.
He's fine.
Listening to his favorite Lionel Richie song, Penny Lover.
We have a website.
Hey.
Yeah. Right. Enjoy it. Like I said, you're going to get maybe, I'm being generous here.
Uh-huh.
40 seconds of internet excitement.
Wow.
Very, very exciting.
You see the bright colors, and then you realize, really, there's nothing to it.
Very good.
You can't hear the radio station on the website, so...
Most important thing.
Why have the website?
Right.
That's why me and Mike have the name, the domain name taken, but why do it?
Right.
Because people would go on and go, oh, that's pretty.
Yeah.
And you go, well, what do you got?
What do you got? I got nothing.
What do you got?
I got nothing.
I voted for Aniston, incidentally.
Ah.
Buzz.
Yes, finally, a West Virginia lottery winner has his money back.
West Virginia!
The $500,000 was in a briefcase in his SUV when somebody stole it. But Jack Whitaker had his money back faster than you can say Jack Whitaker. It was found in a dumpster outside a strip club.
Jack Whitaker.
Same strip club where Jack was spending some time when the money was taken. I'm Buzz Burbank.
Lucky man.
This is the Magic Christian.
On the Don and Mike Show.
No! Website, no. That's it. We got to go. God knows what major announcement we'll be making tomorrow.
Yeah. Always an adventure.
Tomorrow, the announcement.
We're buying a CD machine.
That's it. We got to go. We'll see you tomorrow with the new episode. Tomorrow, Craig and the midget porno.
Right.
On tomorrow's episode. Good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, sir.
Good day to you, pal.
Hey, Rusty.
All my air checks and equipment were stolen.
Suck. Beer meters.
Till we meet again, Sammy Davis Jr. saying, be kind, be nice, and I hope the next performer has the pleasure of having as nice an audience as you've been tonight. And let me leave you swinging.